State University president, Richard Gallo. Oh, we can do better than this. We ask now that you please stand for the invocation. The invocation will be led by Pastor Jerry L. Baldwin of New Living Word Ministries in Ruston, Louisiana.
Bow with me if you will. Father, we're indeed grateful for the opportunity to participate in this homecoming celebration. We thank you for the contributions of James Shaq Harris and Douglas Williams to Grambling State University. And today we thank you for these two universities that will compete. For the administration, the faculty, the staff, the student body, the coaches, and the team.
Talk to them very loud.
From injury, the players can compete hard without injury. We pray now for the spirit of competition.
What's good, everybody? It's T-Lay along with my man OJ, the Juice Man. Live here from Grambling State University. It's homecoming here at Grambling State.
Give me all the honor for what's going to happen to me today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Pastor Baldwin. Please remain standing for the national anthem by the Wu-Tang Tiger Marching Band.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's T-Lay here along with my man, OJ the Juice Man. We're live here from Grambling State University. It's homecoming here at Grambling, man. And you being just recently graduated from Grambling, man.
Yes,
how
sir.
You feel here?
Oh, man, this is my first time being at homecoming and not being an undergrad, so it's a blessing. And to also be here to be able to call a game and a big game at that, a very good game that we're going to have take place here. The atmosphere is beautiful. Everybody's reeling in. I mean, you're seeing all the alumni, everybody sporting their Grambling gear. It's a blackout. I mean, everything about this is beautiful. Everybody that's here, been here, and everybody that's here that hasn't been here gets to see the history. They get to see everybody before them and understand that it's not just them that's been here. It's been a lot of people.
Yeah, and speaking of people that have been here, as we just saw, the man, they just announced a new field, the Harris Williams field here.
Yes.
Thank you to the world famed Tiger Marching Band. Ladies and gentlemen, we would now like to recognize those who made today's B-52 Fly By Possible.
hard to remember it, like, when you're applying, like, faculty will be mean, you know, stuff like that.
Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for some football? Punch your ticket and play the $5 New Orleans Saints scratch-off. From the lottery, win up to $100,000. You can score extra points with extended play and a bonus game on the back. This ticket is a touchdown. You must be at least 21 to purchase.
Oh.
Gentlemen, we would now like to recognize those who made today B-52 Fly-By possible.
We're here live from Grambling State University. It's homecoming here at Grambling State University as Grambling State University getting ready to take on Alabama State, I mean Alabama A&M live here at homecoming. I'm T-Lay Collins along with my man OJ the Juice Man. Man, look, you just recently graduated from Grambling, now teaching and doing the Grambling Sports stuff, man. What is your experience here for Grambling football, man?
This is a lovely time. I think every year that I'm here, it shows the importance in the history. So much things going on, and I think when you look around, you see a lot of people that have been here, and when you look around, you see a lot of people that hasn't been here for a long time, and that's what really makes it all special, because it's just a melting pot of people that has experience and people that still having experience. So that's just really all it is, the beauty of it.
So, man, life right here at Grambling, like, what are some things we can expect?
We're going to expect some good things, but we're going to get in that when we get back. We'll get back.
John, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
Be like the greats? First, believe you are. Greatness requires drip, not like that, like this. The greats aren't afraid to fail. They're fueled by it. Trophies require greatness, But greatness doesn't require trophies, because greatness isn't about what you've done, it's about what you do next.
We are exactly what you think. We are not at all what you think. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. General Motors, honored to sponsor the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
Grambling State University to kick off. The Bulldogs of Alabama A&M University to receive. Alabama A&M. And it looks like ball on the 29.
Sends another man in motion as he looks to the sideline for it, calls for it. Hands it off to his running back, up the middle, trying to find some room, but he is hit around the line of scrimmage. Mike was able to sneak out 1 yard on the play.
And that's going to be great work by our defense. Quentin Talley on the tackle right there, our DB. And our defense is going to have a lot of work ahead of them. They got the number one offense in front of them today. And right now, currently, total yards-wise, we're eighth in the SWAC. Not well.
As he hands it back out to his running back, that's England right there. And he was taken down maybe after a gain of 3 yards, make it third and five to go for Alabama A&M.
Now, the run game is definitely where Alabama is going to like to attack. They have a backup quarterback in today. They're going to have Xavier Langford starting today, and he's been taking all the snaps, but they're going to be on the run game a lot.
Langford hands it off to his running back, even up the middle, looking for the first down, and he is taking down Leggett. It might be just short, but we're waiting on a spot from the referee.
And that is Donovan Eaglin, their main guy as far as the running back position. Donovan Eaglin right now, when it comes to rushing yards in the SWAC, he's sixth. He has 313 total yards, two touchdowns. His team likes to go for the skies. They usually have quarterback Quentin Casey in, who's pretty well, been having a good season. He beat us last year when they beat us 37-31 in a good real close game last year.
First and 10 for Alabama A&M at about the 39-yard line. England in shotgun, calls for it, hands it off, fakes it to his running back, and throws it up the field, and it's knocked down. Great job by the Grambling State Tigers.
Great coverage right there by Cedric Anderson, staying with his man almost all the way through as the streak route was trying to get through, as Xavier Langford saw the streak route left side going up the field, and safety was there on the help. He really did it needed, as Tally had was all over that one, was able to bat the ball down. Surprisingly, didn't come up with an interception there.
Langford in shotgun, single back in the backfield with him. Three receivers to the near side, one receiver to the far. As they look to the sideline for it, the play, as he liked their change of the play at the line of scrimmage. Quarterback calls for it. Hands it off to his running back up the middle, but he is met right there by a Grambling State Tigers. First person I saw in contact right there was number 95 for Grambling State University. That's Carter, the big defensive lineman Carter right there. Was able to.
Javon Carter is one man that you just can't stop. He's a beast. He's a man amongst boys when he comes out there when he plays. I mean, he's a really good defensive, and our defensive line is one of the best in the swag.
Langford at shotgun. You know what I'm saying? England in the backfield with him. Three receivers to the far, one receiver to the near. Quarterback is in shotgun, calls for it, fakes it to this running back, scans the field, got a man, and it is incomplete as he throws it to the sideline of Grambling State University on the play.
And here we go. Now, you're going to be seeing a lot of these celebrations, as you guys can see here. Now, this is good for us. T-Lay, we actually on TV. We can actually show the people what we're looking at. They've been doing this celebration ever since they played Alcorn. And Alcorn kind of gave it back to them after we lost and stuff and all that.
Yeah.
I love the carrying on of the fun that these guys are having. Last year for this squad seems so strict. It seems so serious. And I think they're playing a lot more free and loose this year.
It's going to bring a fourth down for Alabama A&M as the punt team is out and the punt is up. And the Grambling return man fields it around the four-yard line, trying to break some room. Gallant hold around the side. Got some room. He's up to the 20, up to the 30, the 40. Still on his feet, trying to make a shake. Oh, good spin move. Still on his feet. And he's finally taken down in Alabama A&M territory. Great job right there by the Grambling State University special team.
And that right there was a man. Joshua Johnson right there with the return, sophomore from California.
All right, so look, man, timeout on the field. We're going to take a timeout here. Back with more. With 12 minutes and 26 seconds left here in the first quarter. Your score, Grambling 0, Alabama A&M 0. We're back right after this on the Grambling Sports Network.
Jackson King, stay down here, Jackson.
Get him down here.
What's the call? What's the call?
Hey, money.
We're right here.
Get on that side. Y'all get on that side.
Let go.
Back to live action here at Grambling State University. Quarterback in shotgun, hands it out to this running back. That's number three for Grambling State University up the middle for about a gain of 4 yards, making second and six to go for the Grambling State Tigers.
And that's going to be Floyd Chalk. Now, our running backs are very versatile. We're going to have a lot of different looks. Usually we see Chance Williams out there on the field first, but this Floyd Chalk can carry the load greatly. Talbert can carry the load greatly. They have a very versatile running game.
Quarterback and shotgun. Two receivers to the left, two receivers to the right. Quarterback calls for it. He scans the field, got a man. That's number 19 for Grambling State University. Catches it, and he fumbled the ball. And Alabama A&M says they got it.
That one's a tough one.
But was it a completed catch?
We're looking on the replay here.
Yeah. He's down.
He looks down by the ground. Caught the ball and then rolled over there. As you can see on the replay, he rolled over and his shoulder created contact first. So that's going to be down by contact. Yeah, they're going to take a look at that one most definitely. From what we see up here, and I'm so, oh, this is the coolest thing for us to do right now. We can see it. The replay that we saw, he was able to cradle the ball in and kind of curled up over it and fell forward. And when he fell forward, it looked like the ball juggled loose. But, you know, in the rules of football, if you are down to anybody, elbow, a shoulder, a knee, that means you are your butt, your hip, that means you are down. So if after that point, that body part or any of those body parts touches the ground and the ball then fumbles out, that is not a fumble. You are a down man. Now, if the ball loses and juggles loose before that, that is a fumble all day, every day. So that's what they're looking for right now, to see if the ball kind of juggled loose before then or if you really had good possession, because that's another thing too. If you don't have full possession before it catches, it's going to be an incomplete pass.
Yeah, and the other thing is Grambling, the referee gave the possession back to Grambling, so you have to have evidence to show that, you know, that ball came out. And Grambling retained the ball here. So as they come back out, quarterback is in shotgun as he called for it, drops back, scares the field, hands it off. Look, pitch pass to his quarterback, and he is up the field. Grabs the rule, shakes a man, and he is finally taken down. Great job right there by Chalk to just get up the field for Grambling State University.
See, when it comes to Floyd Chalk, he is so underrated as far as what he does for this team and what he does for the overall impact. You see the players walking back right now.
Is there a flag?
Yeah, there is going to be a flag on that one. You see here on the replay screen by Chalk, and he just blows away from everybody. Cut in. He is such a versatile running back. Right now, he's eighth in the SWAC when it comes to rushing yards, and he is not our primary running back. Our number one running back, Chance Williams, is third in the SWAC with 457 yards. But Chalk puts up a good amount of yards himself, 308 what he has on the year so far, and they're definitely walking this one back.
Hey, step the back. He's not playing for us, guys.
Come on! Crawley and shotgun. Carly calls for it, drops back, looks for a receiver, got a man as he throws it in and out of, well, like it was patted down by the defender for Alabama A&M, but great job right there trying to get into his favorite receiver, Rash, right there on the fly play.
And this is going to be one of their best cornerbacks right here, Izume, on the the pass deflection. He was assigned to Lyndon Rash being the veteran, and Lyndon Rash being a really trusted receiver. They put their number one corner, who is Izume, and he is really a long cornerback, and he gets a lot of interceptions, leads the team, and almost a swag in interceptions.
Crawley
in
shotgun, hands it off to his running back. Like this, Chance Williams in the backfield, shakes him, trying to break a tackle, but he is hit for a loss right there. Breaks up third down, third and long for the Grambling State University Tigers.
Try to make that outside zone for Chase Williams to work. He just could not beat out on the corner. It was just so too smothered on that side, and once he got to it, he kind of just got smothered up. Now, what he tried to do at the end was try to cut back, which he should have kind of tried to do before then, but you know, he was just trying to make something work, and his running game is something that's going to have to get a little bit more fluent for this offense to get a little bit more fluent.
Crawley is in shotgun, single back in the backfield with him, and kind of eye formation, hands it out to his running back, trying to bounce to the outside, find room, and it's like there was a Chance Williams again on the play. There's a flag on the play. It looked to be a late hit flag, and it'll be a good sign for the Grambling State Tigers.
Yeah, that's going to be a really good, that was a late hit, and that's an obvious late hit there, as they're going to bring that up a few. Now, it might not give them the first down, but we'll see them get a little bit closer to that territory. As we're looking here, Hugh Jackson talking to the refs. Now let's see where they spot this ball. It's gonna be important. It's gonna be a roughing, it's gonna be unnecessary roughness. See on the replay here, Chance Williams bounced it out, and that hit right there.
It's gonna bring
you up.
Yeah, and it's gonna make, was that a first? Did they automatic first down?
Yep. Automatic first down on that, and the late hit came from number 36 on Alabama A&M side, Lynn Pettyway.
Crawley is his shotgun. Crawley calls for it, fakes it to this running back, scans the field, got a man, and the pass was just kind of behind him on there.
Yeah.
Triple E bring up second down for Grambling State University.
Tries to find J.R. Waters there, and J.R. Waters just hit the ball, was a little bit behind him. Montrell Campbell on the defense right there, and now you're starting to see them do the little celebration back. It's already going back and forth here in this game. I'm telling you, that was the name of the game last game, the Alcorn.
Crawley a shotgun, two receivers to the far, one receiver to the near, sends the man in motion, calls for it, hands it off to his running back as Chalk, and as he is brought down for maybe a gain of 2 yards on the play, brings up third down for the Grambling State Tigers.
And that was a great play defensively there by Jordan Mitchell. Jordan Mitchell being their guy, linebacker there. Last game against when Alabama A&M played Jackson State, Mitchell had 13 tackles on the day. That was the game that they lost 45-30, but at halftime they were down 35-7, and at one point down 38-7.
Crawley and shotgun, Chalk the long back in the backfield with him. Crawley calls for it, drops back, looking for a receiver. Got a man right there on the hitch, and it is complete and brought down short of the first down. Look like it might be short. No, there is a first down. That's enough for a first down for the Grambling State Tigers.
Now, this is Codavius Knighton, a good guy. I got good remarks about. My cousin played with him over there at McNeese State. Really good tight end, really big dude, and really reliable dude as well. They like him a lot.
Probably a shotgun. Calls for it. Oh, fumbled the snap, and wait, I think A&M got it.
That was just a botch play right there. You see, Crawley went down a little bit weird, too.
Yeah, I saw that. A&M got it.
That was just unfortunate. They snagged upon each other. And it looks like Crawley's a little banged up from that as well.
Just a bad snap.
What happened? Yeah, bad snap. I mean, it just did seem like he never really had full possession of it. I mean, it just really popped out his hands. And Alabama A&M was all over. You just seen white jerseys all over. That is definitely a fumble there, and that's going to be a loss. So that's going to be a momentum changer so far in this game, the first one that we've really seen so far.
Engelman's shotgun. Well, Lankford's shotgun. Scans the field, try to find a man like on a post route, but it is incomplete. Bring up second down for the Alabama A&M.
Second down for Alabama. A pass play there and good coverage by our DBs there. And this is going to be where we're going to have a focus. Now, our rush defense isn't really all that well and hasn't been all year, but our passing defense is pretty well. We're almost at the middle of the heap. We're at six when it comes to the swag. We are allowed 212 yards per game.
Lankford and shotgun, hands it out to his running back, and he is met. And guess who's there?
That man, Sonny. That man, Sonny Anderson. I mean, he comes in with such ferocity. I mean, usually when you see, you're going to see here on a replay, not Sonny is going to come down the line. Usually defensive ends, when they have a tackle slants down like that, they stay right down the line. But Sonny IQ is so high when it comes to the game. That's why he's such a highly looked at player, because instead of going right down that line, he went right after the attack, make the running back have nowhere to go. And that's just what you call a smart play there.
Third and about 3 yards to go for Alabama A&M as Lankford comes out and shotgun, empty backfield, and like a man jumped on the play. So that's going to be a false start and going back A&M up.
Yeah, that's going to be good for Grambling State University in their favor, especially as far as having a mishap at Grambling State University. More pushing back from Alabama A&M is going to be great. Now it's a third and long, really long.
Third and long for A&M. Lankford in shotgun, empty backfield as everyone looks to the sideline for the play. Lankford called for it, drops back, scans the field, looks up, got a man, and he overthrew his receiver intended for number four. That's Cameron Young for A&M.
Now, Xavier tries to find his, receiver, number four, Cameron Young. Cameron Young also had him a big game last game out. He had eight receptions, 180 yards, and he also had a touchdown. He led his team in receptions, but he was trying to find him, but it was great coverage by Tally again. Tally has been all over the field so far in this game at that DB position.
Fourth down, and like A&M, like Alabama A&M is going for it as Lankford is still out there on his fourth and long at quarterback. Oh, he punts it.
Oh, wow. Never have we seen.
He punted it.
Tile. I think this is history for us. We have never seen anything like this.
Chad, look, with 6 minutes and 54 seconds to go here in the first quarter, take a quick timeout. We'll be back with more right after this.
Doritos created Solid Black in 2021 to help fuel the initiatives of Black leaders seeking to drive real change. Like Alvin Irby, his vision to spread literacy literally. Or Marvin Pierre, who's empowering our youth with skills that bridge the opportunity gap. Or Jessica Johnson, whose dedication to dreams helps make college a reality. And many more. Check out their stories and help shape change. We are Solid Black. Join us and try another angle.
What are you guys doing?
Learning that HBCUs are not only about networking. There's also secret handshakes.
That's cap. HBCUs do not have secret handshakes, right?
You mean this secret handshake? Cool.
Wow, these guys are almost Cricket 5G fast.
We're kidding. There's no such thing as a secret handshake.
Or is there?
Champions for Life didn't just happen overnight. Since 1920, the Southwestern Athletic Conference, SWAC, has been in the forefront in leadership and excellence in all our athletic programs. There are very few major sports halls of fame that a SWAC athlete is not a member. Hall of Fame coaches who were stewards and mentors to these elite athletes, our tradition, our distinction, our legacy. We are the SWAC, building champions for life.
Welcome back here to Grambling State University's homecoming for Grambling State as Crawley comes out. Grambling take over first and 10. Crawley in shotgun, scans the field, look for a receiver, throws it up the field, got a man, and he catches it. Oh, in and out of his hand. Intended for one of his favorite receivers, Landon Rash, right here on the play.
That is a rare sighting right there to see a big play like that and Landon Rash just have it and then loses it. It's just uncommon. And right there, as you see the nice streak route, and it was a perfectly floated ball from
Crawley. I think the field did it.
Yeah, he got hit by the turf monster, but it was also great coverage on the other end by Ezekiel. He's been doing great all game. He will be. He's a great player.
Crawley hits shotgun, hands it out to his running back like this, number two, Chance Williams, as he keeps his foot, his feet trucking for some good game. Maybe a gain of 4 yards, break up third and six for the Grambling State Tigers.
Chance Williams, 5'10", almost 200 pounds, but I tell you, he runs the ball as if he's something like Derrick Henry. He is a very powerful runner. He's very shifty as well. I mean, he's an all-around great player.
Crawling in shotgun, defense making a shift at the line of scrimmage. Crawley calls for it. Scans the field, going deep again, looking for number 19 at times. He goes up and is in and out of the hands of both the receiver and the defender on the play.
Almost an interception there. Antonio Jones, one of his favorite receivers, one of the top receivers in the SWAC right now. He's number two in the SWAC when it comes to receiving yards, 390, but he has yet to touchdown so far. I mean, our quarterback has 10 touchdowns and none has gone to our number one receiver, but so far Antonio Jones has been having a great year, and so is Crawley. He's doing amazing. He's only second in the yards. He's tied for number one when it comes to touchdowns with 10. And you know what? With all that being said, he has number one in completions. And with all that being said, he only has one interception on the year so far.
Brings up fourth down, fourth and five for Grambling State University as they bring out the punt team. And now the refs blow whistles.
Number 53, Jimmy Owls, back to punt. For the time.
Maybe they just resetting the clock.
Yeah, I think so. Man, it looked like they had. I thought it was a timeout.
Me there. Too.
Yeah, it looked like they were setting the clock.
All right, Grambling punts it. Ooh, bad punt. Good roll, bad punt, but a good roll at the end to get to these back.
Yeah, just a little bit, just to give them a little bit of space. But that one was there, a bad punt, and which is weird. We don't usually see that, but wind is a factor today. We feel it blowing through here right here. Got a flag here. Gonna see what it is. And this is great, homecoming. The crowd is filled up. We have the screen here. We're a little bit more filled in than we usually are.
Yeah.
And this is a great thing for us. We're able to see everything in action, and seeing really what you guys see as well. This is really cool.
The crazy thing about it is, man, A&M side, they brought quite a good crowd.
They brought a good crowd with them as well. I mean, Alabama A&M always know when we play, it's going to be good games. I mean, the last 5 years, I would say, Alabama and A&M and Grambling State University have been the most exciting throughout the weeks that they're playing. The week that they are playing is always the best game of the week, especially last year when they went into overtime and they Grambling State University lost 37-31. It was a great, great back and forth game.
Alabama A&M would take over 1st and 10, like the ball sticks around the like it's the 30, maybe the 34-yard line of Grambling State University. So Alabama A&M will take – oh, are they moving the ball up some more?
They are moving the ball up.
All right, I need you, Travis. I need you all back behind the media line, please.
Don't see anything as far as a flag.
All right, so take that back. It'll be 1st and 10. Alabama A&M take over at the Grambling's 28-yard line. Langford and shotgun calls for it, completes it to his receiver, and he's pushed out around maybe the 11-yard line to be 1st and 10 for Alabama A&M.
Great pass there to find Jacoby Hewitt. Hewitt right there was on a fade route, was able to find the opposite shoulder, which was a great throw by Langford, and the defensive back was there, just couldn't get in the reach of batting that ball out.
Langford and shotgun, single back in the backfield with him. That's a different back we got back there. I can't see his number. Quarterback calls for it, hands it off to the back. Straight up the middle, keeps his legs trucking as he is finally brought down, but not before he gained 5 yards on the play, making 2nd and 5 for Alabama A&M. Ball sits around the 7-yard line.
Yes, that was number 26, was running back Ryan Morrow. And he had himself a little good of a game last time, too. I mean, all these guys that they're utilizing now, they're utilizing and will be utilizing. They'll utilize Eaglin and Morrow. But overall, their running game is just like ours. They have versatile runners, and their passing game is really exceptional. And Langford has been doing what he needs to so far.
Langford and shotgun, Morrow in the backfield with him, calls for it, fakes it to him, then pitches to Morrow. Morrow finds a little around the outside, and he gets in for the touchdown for A&M.
They strike first, Alabama A&M. Same like last year, Ryan Morrow with the scoring touchdown last year. They struck first and with a rushing touchdown as well. But this is different. We're at home, And I think we always start a little bit slow at the beginning of the game. And this is going to be where we're going to show and be in our time being.
All right, so as we get ready for the extra point here, up and the kick, it's good. Your score here with 4:39 to go here in the first quarter. Alabama A&M 7, Grambling 0. Bet right after this.
4 minutes. We're not getting back to this.
While inside the stadium, first aid locations can be found behind both home and visitor concessions area.
Free Whataburger. Early, so we gonna blitz for what we're not.
side goes this way. Alright? So you guys are going to turn the curve.
Kickoff.
Welcome back here to Grambling State University Homecoming. Homecoming as A&M kicks it off to Grambling State University after they just scored here in the first quarter to take the lead 7-0 right here on the newly named Harris Williams Field.
Yeah, I mean, this is kind of, honestly an adjustment to see as well. But I think there's no worry here if you go back to the score and look at what we're talking about this game. I don't think there's any much worry here as far as this team and what they do and what their game plan is. Like we said this even before this game. This is not a first half team. It's not a team that really comes out on explosive plays or a big boom of things. You kind of see them learn and transition during the game and as the game goes. So as the game goes, they get better. So we're going to be seeing what they do now.
Crawling a shotgun, hands it off to his running back looking for room, but he has met. But still was able to gain maybe 1 yard on the play, bring up 2nd and 9 for the Grambling State Tigers.
Cortez Andrews, the linebacker for Alabama A&M, just coming in and cleaning that play up. As we saw tight end really pull around to be a blocker and just kind of got swallowed up as well.
Floyd, quarterback. Just what a great play right there from the quarterback, man. Just was able to fake it to chalk, find his receiver that he sent on like a swing route and was able to connect with him for a first down.
Yeah, the young freshman, Javion Robinson, the shifty man, 5'6", 180 pounds on that play. Great play by Crawley, just sniffing that play out, seeing what's going on.
Crawley in shotgun, fakes it to his running back. Again, same play, just to the opposite side right there. And there's like this enough for another first down for the Grambling State Tigers.
Back-to-back receptions for Javion Robinson, our freshman. And, I mean, he's been utilized all year. And they have not been scared to use him. They use him in any way that he can. And he's really a utility guy, the Swiss Army knife of this team.
2nd and 1 for Grambling State University. Crawling in shotgun. Calls for it. Drops back, scans the field, looking up the field for a receiver and just overthrown through him right there on the play. And
see, this is what they look for all the time, deep routes. This is why Crawley is number 2 in the SWAC when it comes to being the quarterback in general. Only quarterback that's in the SWAC right now that has better numbers or look a little bit better is Florida A&M's quarterback, and everybody knows he has been a guy for the last few years as it is. And Crawley coming in and stepping in this position where he's coming from Alabama State, he's been able to not only just succeed, but over-succeed.
Crawley in shotgun, hands it out to his running back. Running back finds room up the middle, and that's enough for a Grambling State University first down.
And there goes our rushing game. Highly talked about rushing game. There goes Chalk. And you never know who's going to be back there running the ball, but it doesn't really matter when it comes to this team. Overall, the running team has just been great all year. Number 4 in the SWAC when it comes to rushing yards per game.
Crawley in shotgun. Calls for it, scans the field, got a man, that's number 19. What a great move, spins out of it, he's at the 5. Touchdown, Grambling State University.
Antonio! Antonio!
Is that the first touchdown?
That's Antonio's first touchdown. I think I just jinxed it. I definitely did.
In a good way.
Great way. I talked about how he hasn't had a touchdown all season. Antonio Jones with his first touchdown of the season. Now he can add a touchdown to his highly, highly decadent receptions and yards that he's had so far this season. And Crawley, great way to find a great move by Antonio Jones. I mean, overall, against the number 1 cornerback that they have, tall dude, and he was able to just slip and evade that tackle. Antonio Jones showing why he's one of the best to do it.
The kick is up. And the kick is good. 2 minutes and 38 seconds here left in the first quarter, and your score, Grambling 7, A&M 7. As we get ready to joined by the praise again, man. It's always a joy when we get the praise come up here and join us on the broadcast.
just experienced one of those moments when we're on the field naming the Harris Williams Field there at the Arlington Stadium. You know, just kind of growing up, knowing that the legend of Jack Harris, the legend of Dale Williams. And so for our students to be able to actually see these living legends here today, you know, so much that that's often taken for granted. But they were the ones in the trenches really opening doors and kicking down doors for so many to come after. So because of Shaq and Bill, Just right
the middle. That's it. That's how you always like, especially a homecoming like this. And now we're talking about the game, the stands filling up and all that stuff, but outside the atmosphere as well, I'm pretty sure, I think week two when you guys were selling out the tailgate spots, it was already sold out.
Absolutely. And I tell you what, the lines are still a little long outside.
Right.
And I'm sorry for that. But, of course, you know, this is a very different world we live in now.
Yes, sir.
And
yes, sir.
So, you know, when you think about the need for enhanced security, it's just a part of our new reality. And so, again, we apologize if those lines are still going. We're still trying to get in. So by halftime, it should be a complete the stand should be completely full.
Yes, yes, sir.
And the crazy thing about it is coming in, I just want you to know they are doing their job. Because
yes.
Me coming in, I had my backpack. She's like, hey, no, you got to stop. I got to check. I need to check. So look, players, man, being here for homecoming in front of all these people, man, what is Grambling State University homecoming? And for the people that's out there that's listening and watching, what is Grambling State University homecoming?
It is truly a family reunion. It is, you know, all of our, again, greats and some who may have never been on the front page, but who are here. It's like a big family reunion. So we even got, you know, the crazy uncle here and everybody.
Yeah. Everybody got those.
That's right. But it is, it's definitely where everybody is getting together. And I've seen a lot of friends from my era back in the 80s. And just very thankful to see them there. And they've recognized and noticed a lot of the improvements we're making here on the campus. You know, they're saying they like the vibe. They like the direction we're going in. And we're just going to keep making Grambling great. That's it.
Now, it's homecoming. It's all about history. Before we, you know, wrap it everything up, I want to kind of get back into a little bit of your history, something that you remember. Now, you've been to plenty of games and just been around here. What is one of your favorite memories from a homecoming event or a game like this, a big event like this, that you can remember that you would like to share with us?
Well, you know, as I lean up a little bit, I can see my childhood home, okay? So, I mean, I remember walking down the hill and back up the hill.
Yeah.
I can remember, you know, having the world fame Tiger Marching Band uniform on here in the in Eddie Robinson Stadium. I mean, I can remember being here in my Kappa, you know, paraphernalia. I've seen it from pretty much every vantage point that one could, and they all stand out as very memorable opportunities to be a part of Gram fam. And so, again, I'm just grateful to you know, to everybody that I can stand in this you know, in this role. I hate the fact that the team just scored. We got to get some offense.
Most definitely, offense and our defense kind of need to push back a little bit, create a stance. But we really appreciate anything else you would like to say on the exit, and anything you would like to say for the listeners, people that's not here, that will be coming, anything just in general.
Look, I just want to say thank you for all your support. Just keep all of our players in your prayers. Of course, we had JQ here today. He was injured earlier in the season. God is good.
Great to see him. That's
yes,
a really good story.
Yes, sir. God is good. So, again, just thank you so much. Go Grambling.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, Prez. It's always a pleasure having you down here in the booth with us, with the guys, you know, just doing the things that we do as we're getting back into this game. Like you said, Alabama A&M just scored.
One yard. Ingram ran in from the 4-yard But there was a couple big plays from Alabama A&M on their play, man. Langford connected with his receiver number three for a long drive right there to get him in the red zone right there around the two-yard line. And Ingram just punched it in from like 1 to 2 yards out to get the score for Alabama A&M on their drive. So we're still in the first quarter, and your score here is now Alabama A&M 14, Grambling State University 7. The thing about it is, man, both of these teams on paper are the number one and number two teams in the SWAC scoring when it comes to offense. So we expected it this game.
Yeah, offense, when it comes to scoring and total yards, I mean, you're looking at a team that both of these teams are top five when it comes to almost every statistical set. Running yards, I mean, Grambling is in the top five. Is that passing yards, Grambling's in the top five? Offensively, like you said, they're...
Oh, he kicks it out to him, and he got rolled. And he is finally taken out around the 44-45 yard line.
That was a great return there from him in good position. I mean,
shotgun. He got two receivers to the right, one receiver to the left. Sends a man in motion, calls for it, hands it out to his running back. It's number two for the Grambling State University. Bouncing out to the outside, got some room, following his blockers upfield for enough for a Grambling State University first down.
That was an end-around read option right there. They was going to, they're thinking about handing it off to Antonio Jones, which would have probably, not Antonio Jones, excuse me, Javion Robinson, on that on the left side, but they decided to give it a Chance Williams, which he ended up taking it to the left side anyway. It's bouncing out because of the offensive line on the right end has been able to crash down a lot. The defensive line has been able to so on that play, he just couldn't get it.
Let's go. All right, so that's the end of the first quarter. The score here at Grambling State University homecoming. Alabama in 14.
Let's go,
Grambling State.
Let's go,
State.
Come on, DSU. DSU.
G-G-G-G-State.
Join your Lady Tigers soccer team to victory on October 22nd as they face Jackson State at home. Let's go, Tigers!
When you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
What is Grambling? Grambling is growing. It's a community. Grambling is an education. An experience. Grambling is legacy, tradition, and future. What is Grambling? Grambling is all of this and more. Grambling is the place where everybody is somebody.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Let's have a big clap for our friends at supporter of Grambling State University.
Welcome back here to Grambling State University. It's homecoming here as we get ready to kick off the second quarter. And like I said, once again, your score, Alabama A&M 14, Grambling 7.
Now, to run down some stats that we have so far, Alabama A&M has been having the edge a little bit on a couple things. First down, Alabama A&M is leading right now. They have 7 to our 5. Now, when it comes to rushing attempts, they have 12 to our 8. Now, rushing yards, they are kind of really blowing us out the bottom when it comes to that. They have
70 rushing yards to I-21. They're averaging 5.8 yards per carry. We're averaging only 2.6 receptions. We only have, they only have two in the row. Grambling University has four. Receiving yards, they have 38. Alabama A&M has 38. We have 68. Averaging 19.0 is Alabama A&M and 17.0 for Grambling University. Passing yards in general is going to be the same as receiving yards, 38 for Alabama A&M and 68 for Grambling State University. So both of them are just really getting started here, but a lot of ground foot to really work with.
First and 10 for the Grambling State University. Carly and shotgun, and he throws it downfield looking for a receiver, and the receiver could have had it, but it just in and out. But great, also great, was heavily defended by Alabama A&M right there on the play.
Yeah, great defense there by Alabama A&M. Again,
Not really.
Yeah, last minute, it was lost. But that was Campbell on the defense. But it just couldn't locate the ball. It was Marquise Harris, our tight end. It just kind of lost from him. Probably lost it in the sun.
Probably a shotgun. Single back in the backfield with him. There's Chance. Fakes it to him. Got a man right there on the slant. That's his favorite receiver, number 19 right there. And he gets it, and that's enough for a first down, plus more for the Grambling State Titans.
Same exact play that he scored that touchdown on. When he had the in route and cut it back outside, kind of like a spin and going back to that sideline, they could go, cut up field. Antonio Jones
Everybody
is really good at
changing
momentum direction, and direction. I mean, great, great player for that.
Probably a shotgun. Chance in the backfield with him. Callish finds a receiver that's Rash right there on a hitch, and he just steps on a defender. That's number 13 for Alabama A&M. Campbell just stiffed him to the ground.
That is a mean one, as you can see the replay here. Our trusted receiver, Lyndon Rash, and then Lyndon Rash made that man taste grass as he puts him down all the way down to the ground.
Back up behind me, guys, behind me, please.
Chance in the backfield with him, hands it out to him. Chance scant, looking for room up the field, but he is brought down. And like he might have lost a yard on the play. Bring up third and four for the Grambling State Tigers. Ball is on the Alabama A&M, like it's on the 14-yard line. Crawley. Carly looks to the sideline for the play right there. Carly in shotgun. Chance still in the backfield with him as the defense shifts right there on the play. Hands it off to Chance. Chance breaks out to the outside looking for room. Makes his man miss. And I think that's enough for a first down. So it'll be a Grambling State University first down, making first and goal for the Grambling State University Titans. That's first down for the Grambling State University. First and goal, as Chance was able to just dance around and find some room to get enough for the first down for the Grambling State Tigers.
Now, we have the number two offense in the SWAC right now, but when it comes to red zone offense, we're one of the last in the SWAC. We don't really capitalize in red zone situations when it comes to as much as we need to. So, as this team, they're a great offense, but they could be so much better if they were more effective in the red zone.
12 minutes and 29 seconds to go here in the second quarter. Alabama A&M 14, Grambling State University 7. Back right to this on the Grambling.
You want to be like the greats? First, believe you are. Greatness requires drip, not like that, like this. The greats aren't afraid to fail. They're fueled by it. Trophies require greatness, but greatness doesn't require trophies. Because greatness isn't about what you've done, it's about what you do next.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU is all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G? And as a proud sponsor of HBCUs.
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
You want to be like the greats? First, believe you are. Greatness requires drip, not like that, like this. The greats aren't afraid to fail. They're fueled by it. Trophies require greatness, but greatness doesn't require trophies. Because greatness isn't about what you've done, it's about what you do next.
Huge play coming up.
Oh, wait, I can't help it.
Talking about dropping the ball.
I got the score.
Tostitos Hardy Dippers.
Defense, 12 minutes, 8 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Your updated score: Grambling State University 14, Alabama A&M 14.
We are exactly what you think. We are not at all what you think. Past, present, and future. All in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. General Motors, honored to sponsor the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
Did you know HBCUs are a great place to network? Yes! Did you know Cricket has a great network with Speedy 5G and is a proud supporter of HBCUs?
Yes!
Mia, everybody already knows that.
Dante, did you know this is an A and B conversation? So you need to see yourself at.
He knows now.
Through the stadium, it's homecoming. What's up? get back to action. Keeper. Xavier Langford, but we do have a flag. Broken up by number 4, Cedric Anderson. Come on, Grambling Tiger fans. It's third down. Number 6. Hendrick, we do have a flag on the play.
during the play. Holding. Defense, number four. This is 10-yard penalty. First down.
First down for the Bulldogs.
Leave it there. Leave it the other way.
Eight.
Number three on the carry, Troy Chalk, the fourth. I believe that was Jordan Mitchell for the Bulldogs on the tackle. Gain of two on the play, second down. Ball right at the 50. Pass intended for number 31, Knighton. That's incomplete. That'll bring up third down. Number 23 on the carry, Elder. That's a Grambling Tiger first down. All plays at the 33.
Return alert.
Pass complete to number one for the Bulldogs. Gardner, number 20 on the tackle. That's Chris for the Tigers.
Hey!
Come on, Grambling Tiger fan.
Let's go, Keyshawn. Get up
there. Pass incomplete.
Cutting the ball, bitch.
Hey, why y'all got a problem? Like,
it's fourth down.
That nigga don't play?
And then Crunchy can't pin it.
He can't do shit, look like.
False start. Offense number 6. 5-yard penalty. It's fourth down. Fourth down for the Bulldogs.
You see, Cole, I ain't running from no fucking.
Number 47. Punting for the Bulldogs, Austin. Alabama A&M, the second of the half. This is a media timeout.
What are you guys doing? Learning that HBCUs are not only about networking. There's also secret handshakes.
That's cap. HBCUs do not have secret handshakes, right?
You mean this secret handshake?
Cool. Wow, these guys are almost Cricket 5G fast.
We're kidding. There's no such thing as a secret handshake.
Or is there?
Whoa, that's how you do it.
Building champions for life didn't just happen overnight. Since 1920, the Southwestern Athletic Conference, SWAC, has been in the forefront in leadership and excellence in all our athletic programs. There are very few major sports halls of fame that a SWAC athlete is not a member. Hall of Fame coaches who were stewards and mentors to these elite athletes, our tradition, our distinction, our legacy. We are the SWAC, building champions for life.
Join the HBCU family. You become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
Huge play coming up.
Oh, wait,
talking second. About dropping the ball.
I got the score.
Tostitos heart.
What is Grambling? Grambling is growing. It's a community. Grambling is an education. An experience. Grambling is legacy, tradition, and future. What is Grambling? Grambling is all of this and more. Grambling is the place where everybody is somebody.
The Tigers will take over.
Was it blocked?
Yes, it was blocked. Great job right there by the Grambling State Tigers. Looked like, it had to be blocked right there on the plate. So Grambling would take over, man, right here in great field position. And look, with 4 minutes and 29 seconds to go here before halftime, Grambling has to score here. Grambling got to put something in to put some points on the board.
Oh, yeah, they have to. In this game, you have to put something in to get something out. And in this instance, you have to get your offense rolling. Both of these teams, when you have something like this, you have a number one defense, a number two defense, or a number one offense, and a number two offense, it's going to be about who plays it better. Oh, late hits.
Late hit, but no flag
on that one. Oh, my. But this is going to be the a game of the better offenses here, and they're showing it now.
4 minutes, 21 seconds to go here before halftime. And like I say, man, it's homecoming.
No gain
here
on the play. That'll bring up second down.
That house, man. I'm talking about standing room only here at Grambling State University. As we get back to live action, Crawley and shotgun, single back in the backfield with him. Three receivers to the left, one receiver to the right. Hands it out to his running back, finding some room up the middle, and was able to gain 2 yards on the play. Break up, third down, third and six to go for the Grambling State Tigers as the ball is at the 39-yard line of Alabama A&M.
Run by number three, Troy Chalk, the fourth.
Clock steady moving. 3 minutes and 45 seconds to go. Crawley a shotgun. Single back in the backfield with him. Crawley calls for it. Look out field for it. Finds his running back. Completed pass. Breaks a tackle up the field. That's enough for a Grambling State first down.
And I mean, oof. What a move there. What a way to keep this ball moving. We're 3 minutes removed from halftime so far, and it's been able to keep this ball moving to a touchdown. A score right now would put Grambling State University in a good position. Now, you'll want them to cut a little bit more time, right, but a score here would be good news for Grambling.
Crawley, a shotgun calls for it, rolls out to his right, finds a man. That's his favorite running back again, and that's enough for another Grambling State University first down after the completed pass.
Now, we're starting to see a little bit more of Chance Williams and Chalk, but Chalk has been the primary running back in this game so far, catching passes and everything.
Passing down.
So he's been able to be in there and be a big factor. And this is why you got to love our offense, because no matter what, we always have a utility guy. We always have somebody that we can rotate in and loop right back around to.
Crawling a shotgun like there's Chance Williams in the backfield with him as he's seeing Rash on motion. Hands it off to Chance. Chance is met, and he is hit hard in the backfield. Breaks down for a loss of yards for the for Grambling State University.
That was right there. I mean, a blown up play. That's number 46 for Alabama A&M. Dorian Pickett, their defensive tackle, 6'2", 255 pounds. And I mean, all 255 pounds right there. Chance Williams felt.
Brings up second and about 14 to go now for the Grambling State University. Ball on the 17-yard line.
The second timeout of the half. This will be a 30-second timeout.
We get a timeout on the field. 2 minutes and 22 seconds to go before halftime. Your score, Grambling 14, Alabama A&M 14. You're back with more right to this. So, man, we're still live here. 2 minutes, like I said, 2 minutes and 22 seconds to go. Here in the second quarter, you scored Grambling 14, Alabama A&M 14, man. It's Grambling. It's threatening right here to score. It's second and 14 to go for the Grambling State University Tigers. Ball is on the 17-yard line. Grambling comes out and trips to the right. Single back in the backfield with him. Quarterback and shotgun. Calls for a quick pitch to Chance Williams on the play as he finds room around the outside, and he gets back up a little bit past the original line of scrimmage. Brings up third down, maybe third, and like it's going to be maybe third and seven to go for the Grambling State University as the ball is now lying around the 16-yard line. 2 minutes and 10 seconds to go as the clock steady running here in the second quarter. Quarterback is now, like Crawley, went under shotgun. Chance Williams backfield with him. Fakes it to him under pressure, and he is throws the ball and it's incomplete as the defender for Alabama A&M was right there in their face, was able to bat the ball down right there. For an incomplete pass. Brings up fourth down for Grambling State University. So Grambling State University look like they're going to bring out their field goal team here to try to put 3 points on the ball, on the board before halftime. As you hear OJ put his headset on back there.
Man.
And the field goal is up, and the field goal is good. Your score here, 1 minute and 41 seconds to go before halftime. Your score, Grambling 17, Alabama 8 and 14. We'll be back with more right after this.
Your updated score.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs. Committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream. All hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
You want to be like the greats? First, believe you are. Greatness requires drip, not like that. Like this. The greats aren't afraid to fail. They're fueled by it. Trophies require greatness, but greatness doesn't require trophies. Because greatness isn't about what you've done, it's about what you do next.
Hey, Don. What made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
We are exactly what you think. We are not at all what you think. Past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. General Motors, honored to sponsor the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
Take over at the 20, about the 20-yard line right there, 25-yard line.
1 minute, 41 seconds remaining.
Get this thing going as our offense is back out there. Alabama A&M offense has been able to move, and I mean, I think their point and emphasis of everything that's been going on so far is utilizing their quarterback on the run game. And that has been a big difference from what we've been seeing all week long, because usually the only quarterback that would have that we have faced so far is Andrew Boddy, and we didn't even get to play him. So we've seen a running back right now. I'm a quarterback that's using his legs more often than not.
Langford, shotgun, Hanson off to hits running back England. England up the middle, gap room. He's at the in Grambling territory just that quick on a big game for Alabama A&M.
I mean, just broke through right there. Great blocking by Alabama A&M. Seemed like every assignment, blocking assignment that they had was completely taken care of. And, I mean, got to do better work for being in the right place for Grambling State University defense.
Langford in shotgun, empty backfield with him. As he looks to the sideline, calls for it, drops back, scans the field, looking for a receiver, rolling out to his right, directing, got a man wide open, completed to him. That's his, that's number one for Alabama A&M. Gardner, the 5'8 receiver right now.
And like the pass Gardner complete us enough for
Alabama A&M. First down, down, make it first and 10 and go bomb around the 22-yard line at Grambling State University.
That is that is bad news for Grambling State University, because this is an easy drive so far for Alabama A&M. They've been able to pick their what they want. They've been able to get it in motion. And not only that, the fluency. It's all about fluency. They've been able to have that.
Lengthen shotgun. Makes it to his running back. Keeps it up. Keeps it himself. It goes straight up the gut of Grambling State University for a good gain. That might be enough for another Alabama A&M first down. And
time
it is.
Time still rolling.
First and 10 for Alabama A&M. Ball is down at Grambling State University. 12-yard line. And they are trying to move with 42 seconds to go in the ball game. Langford pitches it to his running back. Eagle trying to shake a man, and it's brought down after gaining maybe 5 yards on the play.
I hope Alabama A&M is aware that the time is still running. They've been putting the ball on the ground a lot, knowing that there's only about a few seconds left. There's 30 seconds left in this game, and they've been moving at their own pace. They have to be careful of time management if they want to look to get a score here.
30 seconds to go here in the second quarter. To score Grambling 17, Alabama A&M 14. And after maybe four quick fast plays and strikes, Alabama A&M is already in Grambling State University's territory and threatening to strike here on this drive.
Literally just a few plays. Every play that we've seen so far has been either a first down or very much close to it. They've been able to get chunk yards quickly and very almost systematically. It's almost systematic how they are just driving down this field and picking their plays. Their play selection has also been really great. They've been able to catch Grambling slipping on a lot of time when they're prepared for the run. They're having a quarterback drop back for the pass. When they're prepared for the pass, they're running the ball. They really have Grambling defense on the tip of their toes, and that's a good thing to have them if you want to be an Alabama A&M offense. That's why they're the number one offense, because it's more than the players that they have. Their offensive coordinator and the way that they call their plays and execute their plays is just as important as a player that is playing in the system that he has.
All right, so here we go. Quarterback Langford is out there. It's shotgun, empty backfield with him. Langford drops back, rolls out to his right, looking for a receiver, keeps it himself, cuts upfield, and he is in for the touchdown. Flag on the play, late flag on the play. Let's wait to see what that is.
Yeah. There we go again. Xavier using those legs once again to hurt the defense of Grambling State University. I mean, the rushing game is what we were worried about, but we thought at least the running back.
Right. Offense, number six. This is 10-yard penalty. Great play, second down.
Alabama A&M still take that touchdown off the board.
22 seconds still left.
So like that was holding against Alabama A&M, so that's going to back them up. It's going to make it second and 12 to go for Alabama A&M. Ball is now put at the Grambling State University 14-yard line. 22 seconds to go before halftime. Langford come back out, empty backfield, and Langford in shotgun looks to the sideline for the play. Langford called for it, drops back. Looks upfield, under pressure, rolls out to his left, still trying to roll, trying to find some room, finally taken down. And the tackle was made by number 42 for Grambling State University. That was the linebacker, Darling, right there on the play.
That's going to be good yardage for Alabama A&M, but it's not going to do any justice as it stops the clock. But it's not going to give them a touchdown. That's exactly what they wanted right there. Because now you're going to have to draw up a play that's going to get you in the end zone in a quick amount of time, because if you run the ball here, you're liable to run the time all the way out to zero. If you pass the ball, passing lanes have been kind of tough for Alabama A&M.
Yes, sir. 3rd and 9 to go for Grambling State University. Ball at the 13, about the 12-yard line. Langford in shotgun. Empty backfield. Langford called for it. Scans the field, got a man, and just overthrew his receiver right there on the play. Ball was intended for number four. That was Cameron Young, but wasn't able to bring it in. Incomplete pass, brings up fourth down for Alabama A&M.
What the heck?
That brings up fourth down. Alabama A&M is getting ready to bring out their field goal team. They're going to try to tie the ball game up with 9 minutes and 9 seconds left to go here before halftime. And the kick is up. And the kick is good. 4 minutes, 4 seconds to go here. 5 seconds to go here in the ball game. Your score now, Grambling State University 17, Alabama A&M 17. Take a quick commercial break. We'll be back with more live to this on the Grambling Sports Radio Network.
Grambling State University, the Tigers 17. Alabama A&M University, the Bulldogs 17.
They were able to get quick pops things in, and as in general, I mean, they were actually in the flow of their offense. I mean, if that wasn't a call back, that touchdown would have been easily granted to them, and that's going to be something they're going to go in to make a halftime adjustment. But like we said in the first half, and in what we've been saying all first half, this is not a team that shows up most of the time in this first half. They usually have to go in at halftime, get that halftime adjustment, they come back a different team. So we'll see what happens, especially after this halftime.
A little boot kick right there, a little pooch kick. And it, oh, and Grambling player touched it.
Yeah.
Waiting to see who came up with it.
And you know, it's a scramble, it's a fight. I mean, it's 1.2 seconds left, but.
Grambling keeps it. Grambling retains the ball right there. As there was a little pooch kick right there on the kickoff, and Grambling return player touched the ball and wasn't able to still come up on it. They was fighting for it right there, right before half. 1 second to go here before halftime. Like I said, your score here. Grambling State University 17, Alabama A&M 17, right here before halftime. As Grambling comes out, and like they're just going to, quarterback is going to come out in victory formation just to kneel the ball to go take this into halftime, and that's exactly what's going to happen. They'll take it to halftime. The clock runs down to 0 seconds right there. So we're at halftime here at Grambling State University at the Kennedy Robinson Stadium on the newly named field, Harris Williams Field. Here, your score, Grambling State University 17, Alabama A&M 17. We'll be back with more live this on the Grambling Sports Radio Network.
Okay.
If you want to see the world fame, can I get a yes, sir?
And before we get to the world fame, the Department of Athletics would like to acknowledge the 2022-2023 Grambling State cheerleading team on their national title win in the spring 2023 season. Here to congratulate the 22-23 team, the members, assistant coach Marcus Kennedy, head coach Terry Lilly. We have on the infield Vice President for Intercollegiate Athletics, Dr. Travian Scott, and Grambling State University President, Richard Callow.
Grambling State cheerleader, national champion.
How about a big clap, clap, ladies and gentlemen?
Clap, clap, ladies and gentlemen.
The Department of Athletics would like to acknowledge the 2022-2023 regular season men's basketball co-champions. The Tigers will be receiving their rings on Monday at Tiger Madness. The G-Men completed the most successful season in GSU Division I history, including major wins over Vanderbilt and Colorado. Once again, here to congratulate the 2022 team, we do have the members, assistant coaches, DeVars Walker, Kyle Jones, head coach, Dante Jackson. Let's hear it for Vice President of Intercollegiate Athletics, Dr. Travian Scott, and Grambling State University President, Richard Gallo Jr. How about a big clap, clap, ladies and gentlemen, for the Tigers, men's basketball. Oh, come on, we can do better than this.
Come on, we can do better than this.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time. Miss Grambling State University 2023-2024 and her Royal Court. Miss Freshman, Paris Robinson, is a freshman majoring in criminal justice from Dallas, Texas. She's being escorted by Jalen Jolivet, a sophomore, cybersecurity major from Opelousas, Louisiana. Miss Sophomore, Jakyla Allen, is a second-year criminal justice major from Forest City, Arkansas. She's being escorted by Colin Brooks, a junior business management major from St. Louis, Missouri. Miss Junior, Ariana Slack, is a junior biology major from Fairfield, California. She's being escorted by Cortez Harris, Jr., a senior accounting major from Chicago, Illinois. Miss Senior, Morgan Reese, is a senior biology pre-med major from Haywood, California. She's being escorted by Joshua Elder Davis, a senior mass communication major from San Diego, California. and Miss Grambling State University 2023-2024, Madison Johnson, a senior mass communication major with a concentration in broadcasting from Dallas, Texas. She's being escorted today by Derek Hill, a junior biology major from New Iberia, Louisiana. Come on, ladies and gentlemen, how about a big clap for Miss Grambling State University and her Royal Court. How about another big clap, ladies and gentlemen? Miss Grambling State University and her Royal Court. Ladies and gentlemen, last year we honored the first band of 1926. This year, we will honor the dancers of Rokesis Dance Company, celebrating 75 years and honoring its founder, Catherine Jones Williams, a lady of all seasons who represented class, grace, and sophistication. Let's start with the 1980s. The 90s, the 2000s, and the 2010s and beyond. Director Fred Coulson, this is your show. Oh, come on, Tiger fans, help them out. Class, grace, sophistication. The 1980s, the 1990s, 2000s, 2010 and beyond.
Y'all make some noise one more time for your Orchid.
Mic check.
Check. If you y'all ready for the world fame, can I get a yes, sir? Okay. Grand Fam alumni, make some noise!
The following performance is rated G. The two baddest drum majors to come out on a swag field. They call him Dre from Monroe, Louisiana. DeAndre Hatfield, senior drum major from the late Lancaster, Texas. Chevion Jones, the best to ever do it. Grand fam, this is the moment we've all been waiting for. Since 1926, this prestigious, electrifying, multi-talented band has performed in nearly every major stadium across the world. Africa, Tokyo, Spain, from the U.S. coast to coast, and the NBA All-Star Game, BET, to stadium seats, the whole to the Super Bowl. They know our name. We are the World Fame. It's election day. Make sure you get out and vote. Represents the boot, baby. Make some noise for the boot. Restore some love to the boot. President Bush and Obama, the world inauguration of President Joe Biden. Dance is a hidden language in the soul. The mesmerizing, precise, dynamic orchesis. Yeah, they're gonna make you hit the floor. Jamming to my boo. Ladies and gentlemen, Dora Kisses. Slow jamming to Can You Talk to Me by Jodeci. Get on your feet right now, Griffin! Let me get a chance! Cowan, band assistant Shaniqua Ishmael, the DJ Twins on DJ Bill. Good day.
DJ Bill, good day.
Looking at the screen here, gonna have some visuals. Some replays here, as you can see. I mean, right there, quarterback over. Now, that was one of the plays that only time that we've been able to see him kind of have a miscue was overthrow the ball, I mean, to assist to a point where we really didn't even know who he was throwing back to on the interception. And then Crawley on the other end throwing the interception that was almost right after that. And that interception was very impressive because the cornerback was able to make a beat on it. And this right here, a play, I mean, slant routes and in the middle and in between the hash marks is where they've been really living and being able to get the ball. I mean, it's been a lot of hard hitting, a lot of heavy hats out there on the field. But overall, this has been what we've been seeing so far. Now, Alabama A&M is atop of us when it comes to first downs with 14 to our 13. Now, rushing attempts, we both are even sitting at 21. Rushing yards, though, Alabama A&M has 157 to our 70. They're averaging 7.5, and we're averaging 3.3. Six receptions for Alabama A&M, 12 for Grambling State University. Receiving yards, Alabama A&M has 85, and Grambling State University has 147. Now, when it comes to averages of receiving yards, there's 14.2 for Alabama A&M, and Grambling State University is 12.3. And passing yards, of course, is going to be the same as the receiving yards. It's going to be 85 for Alabama and 147 for Grambling State University.
Man, that's a big offenses right there. And this is something that we expected here in this ball game with both of these teams coming in as number one and number two offensive units here in the SWAC.
Well, most definitely. And another thing to point out about the team stat as well, Alabama A&M is not just an offensive team. Their defense is in the top five as well. They've been able to hold sturdy and be able to be pretty well on that end of the ball as well. So Grambling State University has a tall task. But them being one of the best offenses just 1 week away removed from that number one spot, Alabama A&M just being in that number one spot. We're going to see who really deserves it, who's going to really have that number one spot at the end of this game, and also what defense is going to give us a push. I mean, we've been seeing outstanding play from Grambling DBs in general. We've been seeing them play a lot better than we have all season because we've been having a lot of problems with the DBs. We have great linebackers and great D-line, but we also have problems with the running game. But overall in this game, doesn't look like we've been having problems that much because they've been bending, but they haven't been breaking.
You know, one of the things is, man, Crawley, you really gonna have to come out and show what kind of quarterback he is in his second half, man. Is he really going to, if Grambling want to put this ball game away? And on defensive side, we have to stop this quarterback, this quarterback, Langford. We got to stop him from keeping from spreading us out on this field with these runs and these RPOs that he's doing. As we get ready to kick off the second half, the kick is up, and it is filled by a returnman for Grambling State University, and he fair catch it. So Grambling will take over. Grambling will take over, and it'll be first and 10 around the 30-yard line.
First and 10, and now we're going to see Grambling State University offense come out. And so far, Crawley has been able to do a quite a good job. Other than that interception, even then on the interception, I feel like it was a good drawn-up play. But sometimes a player can change the dynamic of that. And that's exactly what the cornerback did. He changed the dynamic of a good play into a bad one.
Here we go. First and 10 for Grambling State University. Crawley in shotgun, fakes his running back, and he kicked. Throws the ball in a quick slant, and the whack is completed to his receiver number 19 on the play, and that'll be completed. Second down, so bring up second and one for the Grambling State Tigers.
Second and one, that's exactly what they want on the first play, is to get that ball down, moving a little bit, just at their own pace.
Crawley Hand calls for it, hands it out to his running back straight up the middle, and that's enough for a first down for the Grambling State University Tigers. Make it first and 10 for Grambling State University. Ball is now at the Grambling State University's 44-yard line.
And that's exactly what they're here for, is to move the ball at their pace. They've been able to slowly but steadily get the ball for first downs and continue to drive. Now, the problem is getting in that red zone and finishing it off.
Grambling State University quality in shotgun. Hands it off to his running back straight up the gut right there for Grambling, and he is hit. Maybe got back to the line of scrimmage, bring up second and 10 for Grambling State University.
Now that's what it, now we're going to start looking them, starting to spread this off defense out a little bit. They've been passing the ball, finding their little hitch routes, slants, quick, and now they're going to run the ball a little bit in the inside. That's the name of the game. They're getting back to their offensive game plan that they started with.
Second down, second and 10 for Grambling State University. Crawley is in shotgun. Single back in the backfield with him. That's like that is Chalk in the backfield with
him? Yeah, that looks like it's Chalk.
Hands it off to Chalk. Chalk bounces out to the right side of the field, and he is taken down after gaining maybe 4 yards on the play. Brings up third down for Grambling State University.
They're sticking to spreading this defense out. They have showed us a couple pass plays to start off with. Now they're going to run the ball because now we're seeing the defense kind of spread out a little bit. Now they're going to get in tight. Now we might see them take the skies because it's third down. And this is the kind of game plan that they're doing. They're taking a little bit from Alabama A&M, confusing the defense, keeping them on the toes as we see a little –
we see, shotgun, but we see
Presley, the tap, okay.
They got three receivers to the left, three receivers to the right, got a man wide open, and that's Rash, and it's in and out of Rash's hands, but like the referee throw a flag, could be pass in the field.
Yeah, and that ball just wasn't thrown on the right spot for Lennon. I mean, he was wide open. If that was ahead of him so he could lead on and kind of speed up for that ball, I think we're looking at six right there, but pass interference will do instead.
Man, we're joined in the studio right now by a former Grambling State University receiver. Not only Grambling State University receiver, man, but, man, you did numbers when you was here at Grambling, man. Got Chad in the building with us. How you doing, man?
I'm doing well, man. How y'all doing, man? It's a blessing to be here with y'all today, man.
Man, it's homecoming here at Grambling, man. What is your experience, man, playing here at Grambling State University, especially around homecoming?
Man, homecoming experience here is unmatched, man. The energy level. The food smoking in the parking lot, you know, man, everything is just everything here on homecoming, man. You got people coming up the stairs. I'm looking at everybody in the stands right now and smiles on fans' faces right now. Everybody chilling with their friends from 5 years ago. Hey, man, it's all good vibes today and nothing's going to break that.
Now, the great Chad Williams here that we have. A question now, you watching football, you're a player. You see it from a different perspective. Of course, you're here for homecoming. Mm-hmm. But in this game so far, what are some things that you would say that you've seen that you could kind of pull away from a football mind perspective?
Well, the Grambling State Tigers, you know, we're going to do a good job of moving the ball. But it's just those key little things like getting that key block or being more disciplined on special teams, not throwing that block in the back, not getting that extra holding call. Great way of coming back to the ball right there by 19. Yeah, not getting that extra holding call, just really just playing sound football and doing the things we work during the week, you know?
Yeah.
We work red zone, you know, we work in red zone, we're working first or second or third down, man. We need to execute and, you know, just do it the Grambling way.
Oh, most definitely. Now, we like to go back a little bit of history, memory lane for you know, homecoming, because this is what it is. I mean, a lot of people come back to kind of relive the memories that they have. So we want to relive one of yours. Now, playing football or just being here at Grambling, what is a memory that you could say for a homecoming environment, spirit, doesn't even have to be homecoming, that you can remember that will really, you know, either – tell us about how your experience of Grambling was or just how you felt about Grambling.
Nice by Rash. Out on the three, nice. Yeah, my experience at Grambling State University, man, is unmatched, like I said earlier. Then for homecoming, my senior year homecoming, we played Pine Bluff right here on this stadium. The turf wasn't here. It was some beautiful grass right here. Eddie Robinson had the sun shining real nice and bright. No clouds were out that day. And we beat them boys 70-0 the Grambling way. They thought they were going to get a scratch on the board, but we wasn't going for it. We came out. We executed and we did a 70-0 on Grambling way on homecoming. A lot of excited fans, a lot of dancing in the stands by the fans, a lot of waves in the stands by the fans, and that was an amazing day, man. That's just embedded in my mind. That's something I'll never forget.
Oh, most definitely, as we see.
Oh, great.
Looks like.
That's touchdown. Crawley keeps it himself right down the drive. Right there, Crawley gets it, keeps it himself on the 5-yard line, and runs it in for a Grambling State University touchdown, and they strike first here in the third quarter with 10 minutes and 41 seconds to go.
From now on, it's all about us. Starting a family, buying a car, our first home.
They told you to open an account, then turned you away. They said,
and the kick is good. 10 minutes, 41 seconds. In the third quarter, the updated score. Grambling State University.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU is all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
From now on, it's all about us. Starting a family, buying a car, our first home.
They told you to open an account, then turned you away. They said, come back when you're ready. You said, we're ready now.
I know we're gonna make it.
Hope makes it happen. Thousands of your neighbors, many who never had a bank account before, improved their lives with Hope Credit Union. You can too. Brighter futures begin with Hope.
Attention all Medicaid beneficiaries. You can now qualify for free cell phone service with unlimited talk, text, and high-speed data. You heard that right. You can now get your cell phone service and high-speed data absolutely free from a government program called the Affordable Connectivity Program. Just call 800-211-7670 right now to see if you instantly qualify. All callers can qualify based on your income or if you receive assistance from federal public housing.
Coach here always orders his...
Their contribution to Grambling State Athletics and the university. It's time to get back to action.
Trent, let's go. Let go, Trent. Right down there.
Tanner Rinker, number 38, will kick off.
Too many yards. Too many yards.
Tackle by number 8. I believe that was Smith for the Tigers.
Number three
for the Bulldogs.
Jacoby
Hugh with the run. Bulldogs taking over at the 34. Number 9. First down for the Bulldogs. Number 16 on the keeper. Number 57 on the tackle. Lewis Matthew.
Hit the ball. Hey, hey. Pump it.
Come on, Grambling Tiger fans. It's third down. Number 16. check your pockets. Lanaya Young, Erica Thomas. Harry O'Brien. And Regina Howard. Please check your pockets. And the press box is. The Distinguished 10 program was created to honor 10 Grambling State University graduates who have demonstrated excellence in their industry and community through the personal and professional achievements. These remarkable individuals exemplify outstanding leadership in the areas of business, research, public service, and collective endeavors. Tiger fans, join us as we honor the inaugural class of the Distinguished 10. Dr. Farrah Amber Cameron, class of 1999. Dr. Evelyn Ford Braden, class of 1968.
She about to get it.
Ophelia Nicole Davis, class of 2003. LaShawna Hurst, class of 1995. Chris Hutchinson, class of 2005. Dr. Jocelyn Pickens, class of 2000. Dr. Lamar Schmidt, class of 1994. And Dr. Philippa K. Wallace, class of 1999. Number 82, Joshua Johnson with the rainbow. The shoestring tackle. Carry by number 2, Kenneth Williams. We do have a flag on the play.
That is not ideal, and that's definitely going to be flagged every time they see that. Yeah, he added insult to the – he added salt to the wound as it was already going to probably be a flag, but now it's going to move it even further up because of that. You see here on the replay that we have, screen, we're a little fancy today. You see that, yeah, they picked him up and dropped him. That's already unnecessary. That's unnecessary roughness as it is right there because the whistle was blown. And then the taunting, that's –
Crawley gets shotgun, two receivers to the right, hands it out to his running back. That's chalk up the middle, straight on the inside zone for a good game. And that'll be enough for another first down. Be first and goal for the Grambling State Tigers with the ball now on the 3-yard line of A&M.
this is a great job by their offensive line to get the defensive lineman to slant left and for the running back to then take the advantage and go right.
Charlie, a shotgun. Crawley calls for, look for a receiver and try to catch him on a quick slant, but it's incomplete.
Oh, that one was very tight coverage on Antonio Jones. And Antonio Jones is not the biggest guy, but that ball was placed in the right spot. Just couldn't get it reeled in, as you can see right there. It was the cornerback is behind Antonio Jones. And Crawley was able to get the ball right in front of his receiver, just couldn't get it to reel it in. Great pass, no execution.
Crawley and shotgun, two receivers to the right. And there's flag on the play, false start against Grambling State University, so that's going to back him up five yards.
You take three steps forward to take four steps back in a situation like that. They able to move the ball very close to their end zone and then a false start to bring it back. But Grambling State University is still very much in this, but third and being pushed down, pushed back like that is a tough situation.
Makes it third down, third and goal to go for the Grambling State University. Ball is now on the 8-yard line. And Crawley is in shotgun. Like there's Chance Williams in the backfield with him. Three receivers to the right. And now we got a timeout on the field. Like it's timeout Grambling. Eight minutes and 22 seconds to go here in the third quarter. And this has been one of those games, man. Yeah. Back and forth, back and forth.
Back and forth. It's like a game of tug of war. Both of these guys are pushing and pulling and getting everything, giving it all they got. But it's no real side winning so far. No real side winning so far, as we are seeing. And Grambling State University, I mean, they've been putting up a good effort, but right here, right now, is where you put up a score. You have to. I think with both these teams, the way their offense operates, you have to put up a score to every possibility, chance that you can. Every time you touch the ball, you want to put a score up, because if not, it's an opportunity that the other one will.
And it's one of those situations, man, that, you know, with both these teams going back to back like that, it's going to come down to who defense going to stop who.
Yeah.
Here in this ball game. As we're back to live action, Crawley is back out in shotgun. Single back in the backfield with him. Two receivers is stacked to the right side of the field. As we got a stop in action again as the referees run up there. 8 minutes, 22 seconds to go here in the third quarter.
That's what they're getting together, that clock.
That clock, yeah.
In the clock. We've seen the clock run a little bit more than what it should.
And they had a they was doing something down there on the other end of the end zone.
So perfect timing. I think they probably just took that time to get that out real quick.
Crawley gets shotgun, single back in the backfield with this chance. Crawley drops back, scans the field, passes the chance right down the left side of the field, breaks the tackle, and is pushed out of bounds close to the 3-yard line, making 4th and 3 to go for the Grambling State Tigers.
Great move by Chance Williams. Literally slipped up under a guy and then was a powerhouse and ran one dude over. But if it wasn't for the second tackler there, I think Chance Williams would have broke free. But just short again, and Grambling State University is going to have to settle for a field goal, what we saw not too long ago again.
So Grambling State University brings out their special teams here as they get ready to kick a field goal here with 7 minutes and 53 seconds to go here in the third quarter. And the kick is up, and it's no good. No good. And Grambling really needed those points here.
That was a very important one to get through right there. And like we said, every opportunity you have to score, you're going to want to take it. And that's one. That's the first one missed by Grambling State University. First opportunity to score missed by Grambling State University. Now it's time to put the Grambling's defense on the clock and see if they have enough time to stop them. Because right now, Alabama A&M has been able to really move the ball with fluency. The quarterback has been a big problem for Grambling and really just been able to – and not been able to really stop him at all.
And that was pretty much well in the Grambling State University kicker Winker's range, but he just kind of shanked that thing and came up incomplete. So Alabama A&M would be taking over at the 20-yard line, be 1st and 10 in shotgun. Calls for it, keeps it himself, rolls out to the right side of the field, and finds a receiver. It's a completed pass for a gain of maybe 5 yards on the play.
Gotta stop these chunky short plays. I mean, 5 yards is 5 yards, but 5 yards added up for each down and each play, that's gonna be a scoring drive.
Okay, it was a penalty on the play against Alabama A&M.
Down.
So that's gonna back Alabama A&M up 5 yards. So now take that completed pass away. It'll be first and 15 for Alabama A&M, and the ball is now on their own 15-yard line. Quarterback is in shotgun, sends a man in motion. Langford, pitches it to his right back receiver on the lid. Reverse play, and he is around the left side of the field, up the field, and he's finally taken out of bounds and hit around the 28, 29-yard line. So around the 29-yard line, going to make it second and one for Alabama A&M.
Gardner.
That'll
bring up second down.
Six minutes, 33 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Your score is still tied up. Grambling State University, 24. Alabama A&M, 24. Quarterback Langford is in shotgun, sends a man in motion, hands it off to his running back straight up the middle, and he is tackled, but it's close to a first down. And it is a first down for Alabama A&M. Makes it first and 10 for Alabama A&M. Ball is now at about the 30-yard line, about their own 30-yard line, as Langford is in, and as QB. And you got Marrow in the backfield with him now. So Langford is coming out of shotgun. Marrow single back in the backfield with him. Two receivers to the left, two receivers to the right. Quarterback calls for it. Hands it out to Merrill, trying to find some room, but he is taken down for a loss of yards on the play, and then met in the backfield by Sonny Anderson right there for a loss of yards. Breaks up second and 12 to go for Alabama A&M. Ball now at the 27-yard line.
Second down, Bulldogs.
5 minutes, 17 seconds. Clock steady running here in the third quarter. Your score, Grambling, 24. Alabama A&M 24, one of those situations that this game has been going back and forth. You score, they score, one of those situations. Langford shotgun, quarterback drops back, scans the field, finds a receiver up the field close to a first down, as Langford was able to connect with his favorite receiver, Cameron Young, right there, the 5'9", 175 senior out of Mobile, Alabama, and it's close for a first down, but not quite enough. Bring up third and 2 to go for Alabama A&M. Four minutes, 36 seconds to go here in the third quarter. And clock is steady running as Langford brings his squad back out. Langford come out in shotgun. Merrow in the backfield with him. Two receivers to the left, two receivers to the right. Send a man in motion. Calls for it, hands it off to Merrow up the middle, and that's close to a first down as he's taken down. And that is enough for Alabama A&M first down. Makes it first and 10 for Alabama A&M. 4 minutes and 14 seconds to go here in the third quarter.
And then with the first down.
Merrill sends him out, kind of flank. Langford is in shotgun, barking out orders to his receivers and running back. Langford, single back, is the only back in backfield, calls for it, scans the field, got a man on the slant, hit in and out of his hands. Great job right there by Grambling State University cornerback Cedric Anderson right there to kind of put his hands in there and draw that ball loose right there on the play. It's going to bring up second down for Alabama A&M. 3 minutes and 44 seconds here in the third quarter. Langford comes back out, shotgun, single back in the backfield with him. That's Merrow. looks to the sideline for the play. Langford called for it. Keeps it himself straight up the middle. Finds some room around the left side of the field. He got enough for a first down. Still on the feet. He's up to the 30, the 25. And, man, we can't just get to nothing with this quarterback today. As Langford was able to get the first down and more. About a gain of about 20-plus right there on the play. First and 10 to go for the Alabama A&L. Ball is now at about the 25-yard line of Grambling State University as they're trying to drive to get a touchdown here. Langford, the quarterback, in shotgun. Like Merrill is in the backfield with him. Quarterback calls for it, fakes it to the running back, keeps it himself, makes a man miss, and like he got enough right there for maybe another yard, so make it second and 9 to go for Alabama A&L. Two minutes and 44 seconds left to go here in the third quarter. Alabama A&M with the ball on Grambling's about 23-yard line. Second down, second and 9 to go. Langford in shotgun. Merrill is the single back in the backfield. Will three receivers to the right, one receiver to the left. Langford called for it. Throws it up, got a man wide open. And that is touchdown for Alabama A&M as he was just able to float the ball right over the defender head for Grambling State University. That was Cedric Anderson, and then was able to bring it in for a touchdown for Alabama A&M.
Yeah, right now this is bad news. This is exactly why I said Grambling needs to capitalize on their scoring, because Alabama A&M has been moving like every time they touch the ball, they're willing to score. And you see there, running game on the ground was what hurt Grambling and has been from the quarterback. But right then and there, he used the arm to finish it off. I mean, this is a tough one for him.
As we get ready to wait for the extra kick, the extra point kick is up and it's good. With 2 minutes and 21 seconds left to go here in the third quarter, your score now, Grambling State University 24, Alabama A&M 31. Back with more right to this on the Grambling Sports Radio Network.
This is it, our last night sharing a room. Tomorrow, we'll be in our new home.
They told you buying a home would take years, but didn't help you start. Still, you kept trying.
You'll have a yard to play in, a place to dream.
Hope makes it happen. With tailored mortgage solutions, Hope Credit Union makes home ownership happen for thousands of people, regardless of income or credit. Brighter futures begin with Hope.
Building champions for life didn't just happen overnight. Since 1920, the Southwestern Athletic Conference, SWAC, has been in the forefront in leadership and excellence in all our athletic programs. There are very few major sports halls of fame that a SWAC athlete is not a member. Hall of Fame coaches who were stewards and mentors to these elite athletes, our tradition, our distinction, our legacy. We are the SWAC, building champions for life.
When you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
A&M 31, Grambling State University 24, with 2 minutes and 21 seconds left to go here in the third quarter. And like this, once again, what we said, man, we got to find a way to stop this quarterback Langford from running on us.
It almost seems like both of these teams' defenses is non-existent today, as offense has just been the key of the game and really been overwhelming for both teams.
And that's a kick, it's up, and Grambling grabs it and just falls on it. And we'll be taking over like about the 29-yard line. So Grambling take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
You realize they didn't want to kick it back deep to number 82, Johnson. Yeah. Johnson right there, because, I mean, he's been able to get good yards off of everything. And Miles Crawley, as you see his numbers there, 1,348 yards, 11 touchdowns, 4 interceptions on the year so far. And that 59.1 completion percentage. Like I said, he has the most completions in the SWAC right now. He's number one, and he's number one now as of right now, depending on Florida A&M and their game as far as touchdowns. So he has been having a great season, but right now he has to even have a better game to finish this one off.
Crawley, a shotgun, hands it off to his running back, Chex Williams, trying to find room around the right side of the field, but can't find anything. Brought down, maybe got back to the line of scrimmage, make it second and 10 for Grambling State University.
Second and 10 for Grambling, and that's got pretty much literally stood up there as he was lifted off his feet, airlifted there. Chance Williams has not gotten as many carries as we thought he would this game, but it only can go up from here.
Ball on the 29-yard line, pitch to Chance Williams as he moves his feet and loses some yards on the play. Brings up third and 11 now for the Grambling State Tigers. Crawling in shotgun, two receivers to the right. Crawley calls for it, drops back, scans the field, looks up for a man, and tried to find Chance Williams right there on a wheel route across the middle of the field. And a defender right there for Alabama A&M was right there to bat the ball down. So it's going to bring a fourth down, fourth and 11 to go here for the Grambling State Tigers. They bring out their punt team.
And this is not, I mean, Alabama A&M, it seems like their defense and their offense has kind of racked it up since halftime as well. The defense has been able to not really get much of a stance or move too much. We saw them in good field position, couldn't really move, kick the field goal and miss it. Now they're just straight up stood up on the three and out.
The punt is up. Alabama A&M. Return man fields it around the 38-yard line, brings it up to about the 50 at the 45, still got room, got a block at the 30 to 20, and finally taken down around the 19-yard line. So special teams for Alabama A&M put them in great position.
Put them in great position. Once again, they're in scoring range. They're not too far from the end zone, and it doesn't really matter. They've been a lot further than this and been able to move the ball quickly and fast. And we got a minute left in this third quarter. This is very critical time because Grambling State University wants to get back into this. Two touchdown lead is going to be tough going into the fourth quarter for Grambling to really recover from. So overall, Grambling defense is going to be really the standpoint here. Has to be the standpoint. At first, we were talking about these top tier offenses going back and forth. We're really going to see these defenses have to go at it. I mean, Grambling's defense is going to have to work a lot harder than Alabama A&M's right now, especially because with the position that they're at and where they're backed up to. But Grambling has all possibility to do it, just haven't seen them really accomplish anything yet.
The first and 10 to go here.
Attorney Alvin Washington. Handling personal injury and wrongful death cases anywhere in the state of Louisiana.
They got the sticks wrong, huh?
Yeah, they got the sticks a little for too far back. Or at least the defense is sitting there standing at the wrong spot.
Today's field goals are sponsored by Proper Emergency Services.
Yeah, this went from Grambling really going neck to neck from Alabama A&M kind of pulling away. And this is all due to what?
All-season ticket holders.
This is due to defense. I mean, one offense really has a game plan that they're not going to stray away from because it's working. Getting their quarterback to run, running the ball with their running back a little bit, and then passing it to finish everything off if everything else goes south. And our offense is now kind of trying to find out some new stuff. We're getting uncomfortable. They have pushed us out of our comfort zone of our offense, and now we're having
a flag on the play.
It was a flag. Oh, so that just.
And then that just moved them up 15 more yards. So now it looks like Alabama A&M will be taking over first and 10. At the Grambling State University's 10-9 yard line. So just like that, they are in Grambling red zone.
Just like that. Didn't even have to move a muscle in that one right there, and they're already in immediate almost scoring range. And this is
as the quarterback hands it off to England as he keeps his feet trucking as he goes straight up the gut of Grambling State University for about an 8-yard gain. So it'll be first and goal.
Got a player hurt. Really hurt, too. That's Javon Carter. He tried to make it off the field there, but just couldn't.
Time out on the field.
That doesn't, that's even more bad news for Grambling State University as one of their best defensive linemen goes down on that play. We got only 38 seconds left in this third quarter, but it is not spelling good news for Grambling State University in the position that they're at right now.
It's not. And one of the things that's killing us right now, man, you have a few things, man. The special teams right now.
Yeah, the special teams.
Setting the Bulldogs up in perfect field position.
Plus, and a couple of times with the bad punt there when we was in the end zone, the bad punt. A couple of times where we had flags while we were on special teams. Special teams has hurt us a lot, and the same thing happened last week. Remember, you asked me what happened in the game last week, because you know T-Lay wasn't able to be there last week, and the punter, our punter, had a bad snap from our long snapper. He needed, and that gave Alcorn State great position. They scored, and then ever since then, the game was never really the same. The identity of the game changed.
And something else I'm saying, man, the defense is really overplaying plays right now, setting up big plays for Alabama A&M also as the quarterback hands it off to England straight up the middle, and that's another touchdown for Alabama A&M.
Too easy for the running game. I mean, it's almost as if he was able to just blow past there. And he's a big running back, but our rush defense, I told you that they're one of the bottom of the last. They're the last team. They're at 12th spot when it comes to rush defense. They allow 212.5 rushing yards per game. 212. That is a really a large number, because some running backs are happy to even reach 150.
Right.
So to get 212, or most teams are happy to even have 150 yards rushing on the night, but to average 212 is quite one to see.
And the kick is up, and the kick is good with 46 seconds left here to go in the third quarter. You'll score now. Alabama A&M 38, Grambling State University 24. Take a quick commercial break here on Radio Wise. We'll take a quick commercial break. We'll be back right after this on the Grambling Sports Radio Network.
Look, man. Hanging in there like a loose one.
Hey, I hear that. Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
I like that.
It's just a lot been going on, man, especially for Grambling State University right now. They gotta find a way to get back into this ball game, because Alabama A&M, like, they have taken the air out of this home of the ground.
Yes. We see them. The crowd is kind of now dead. I mean, everybody's trying to find their way. Not everybody, but a lot of people are finding their way to the exits, because Alabama A&M has really put themselves in comfortable position in this game so far to pull away. And like I said, this game is going to be neck to neck until somebody, one of these teams offensively can pull away. And Alabama A&M is showing to be that team so far.
Kick is up, and Grambling field the kick and just fall down on it around the 30. Like it's going to be around the 34-yard line. So that's where Grambling is going to be first and 10 at about the 34-yard line. They're on the 34-yard line.
And it's one thing to take the air out of the crowd, but it's another thing to take the air out of the team as well. And that's what we're hoping that we're not seeing here, is that Grambling University football team has still some breath of air in them, some breath of life in them to really get this game, because you're two touchdowns away. But, hey, the game isn't over.
Crawling a shotgun, two receivers to the left, two receivers to the right, hands it off to his running back on a draw play, and he is hit But not before gaining about 5 yards on the play, making second and 5 to go for the Grambling State University Tigers. Ball is now on the Grambling State University 40-yard line.
Now Grambling's offense is now in a hurry up. Like I said, just uncomfortable, doing things that they haven't really done all season.
Crawley, a shotgun, drops back under pressure, looking for a receiver, and just kind of threw that away as he had a man right up in his face. That was number 4. The big defensive end for Alabama A&M. Hayes was in Crawley's face on the play, forcing him to throw it away.
Zarion Hayes, I mean, he's not unfamiliar for that. When it comes to tackles for loss, he's in the top 10 in the SWAC. He's been doing his thing all season long. Last game, he was really doing a great job against Jackson State, disrupting the running rushing lanes.
Crawley, a shotgun, calls for it. Dumps it to his running back, Williams, finding room across the field, up. And he is good. That's enough for a Grambling State first down. Great job right there by Chance Williams.
Chance Williams in these screen plays, and also Floyd Chalk in these screen plays, have been able to get a lot of production out of these plays because the blocking on those screen plays is tremendous. The offensive line for Grambling State University, they aren't the top tier of the top tier. They aren't the best, but they are really good at a lot of certain things. They have a lot of strong points. And at least it wasn't a lineman.
And that was holding on the play, so.
At least it wasn't a lineman. I didn't jinx it that time.
True.
It was a tight end on the play. But the offensive line, you have to give them a little bit of credit. And also in this game, something you want to look at that's been hurting us a lot is what we just seen there. Flags, undisciplined plays, holding, things that's really been just bringing things back. And that's something we've seen all season, right?
Makes it 3rd and 1 for the Grambling State Tigers. Ball is now on the 44-yard line. Grambling's 44-yard line is.
And that's the end of the quarter.
And that's the end of the fourth quarter right there. So with your score, Grambling 24. That's the end of the third quarter. I'm sorry.
What is Grambling? Grambling is growing. It's a community. Grambling is an education, an experience. Grambling is legacy, tradition, and future. What is Grambling? Grambling is all of this and more. Grambling is the place where everybody is somebody.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
You want to be like the greats? First, believe you are. Greatness requires drip, not like that, like this. The greats aren't afraid to fail. They're fueled by it. Trophies require greatness, but greatness doesn't require trophies. Because greatness isn't about what you've done, it's about what you do next.
Hey, John! What made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU is all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
Our last night sharing a room. Tomorrow, we'll be in our new home.
They told you buying a home would take years, but didn't help you start. Still, you kept trying.
You'll have a yard to play in, a place to dream.
Hope makes it happen. With tailored mortgage solutions, Hope Credit Union makes homeownership happen for thousands of people, regardless of income or credit. Brighter futures begin with Hope.
Instead of just getting 2 yards, they want to
they're still in their comfort zone.
As we get ready to kick off the fourth quarter here, Grambling 24, A&M 38. Grambling got the ball here on the 44-yard line, on their own 44-yard line. Crawley gets shotgun, sends a man in motion, calls for it, hands it off to his running back, and Crawley kept it himself, but fumbled the ball. Alabama A&M picks it up. And Alabama A&M will be taking over after the turnover.
We have a fumble.
That one is a tough one. Great game by Crawley as he was taking it upfield for the first down, and he had a good run ahead of him, but a big hit at a point of contact. That is exactly where he hit the ball, was the point of contact. Yep. And that is an important thing to know, because during this game of football, you can lose the ball any second if you get hit in the right spot. An elbow, I used to play a little running back. If you get hit in that elbow, you losing that ball. You get hit in the elbow good enough. In that situation, it looked like the helmet had made contact with the ball, and the ball popped out, and Crawley couldn't get on top of it. And that is another unfortunate fumble loss for Grambling State University. And it's 14 minutes and 46 seconds left on the board. But if there's another touchdown scored here by Alabama A&M, that may steal the game.
Oh, tough situation right there for Grambling State University as they turn the ball over and give it back to this high-power offense of Alabama A&M Bulldogs right now.
Let's get back to action.
That offense back on the field, and they be taking over first and 10. Ball is at the about the 47-yard line of Alabama A&M as quarterback keeps it, overthrow his tight end on the play.
Pass intended for number 88.
For Alabama A&M.
Yeah, this is never a good thing when you start seeing the opposing team start having A&M rotate players in or backups. That's the backup tight end right there that they try to get a pass to. And overall, Grambling State University is defensively going to have to step up, because right now they're in big trouble if there's another touchdown scored right here and there.
Langford is shotgun like this. Monroe in the backfield with him as he looks to the sideline for the play. Hands it off to the running back up the middle for about a five-yard gain.
Number 26 on the carry, Ryan Morrow. Tackled by number 9 for the Tigers, Anderson. Come on, Tiger fans. It's third down.
For Grambling State, for the Alabama A&M Bulldogs. Third and about 5 to go for Alabama. 14 minutes and 15 seconds to go here in the fourth quarter. Your score, Alabama A&M 38, Grambling State University 24. As Langford comes back out in shotgun, Morrow in the backfield with him, send him in shotgun. As he has shotgun, Morrow in the backfield with him. Quarterback drops back, look for a receiver. Got Morrow on a wheel route and overthrown him.
Pass intended for number 26, Ryan Morrow.
For Alabama A&M.
Almost big succession there, as the wheel route was almost wide open on the play. And
that'll bring up fourth down
just
for the Bulldogs.
Just couldn't find him as he overthrew it. It was two plays right there, overthrown. And good luck for Grambling State University, because if it wasn't, that would have been first down. But right now, they're giving it a hold. They're standing as there's a fourth. About five.
And Alabama A&M offense like they're a stand on the field, but it's one of them situations, again, that you never know. We might see the quarterback Langford just kick it, which we will.
Yep.
And he kind of kicks it, and it's Philip bouncing, bounce. Oh, did he try? What is going on? What?
What was that?
I don't know. All right, so look, man, with 13 minutes and 41 seconds to go here in the fourth quarter, you score Alabama A&M 38, Grambling State University 14. We're back with more right to this on the Grambling Sports Radio Network.
You want to be like the greats? First, believe you are. Greatness requires drip, not like that, like this. The greats aren't afraid to fail. They're fueled by it. Trophies require greatness, but greatness doesn't require trophies. Because greatness isn't about what you've done, it's about what you do next.
We are exactly what you think. We are not at all what you think. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. General Motors, honored to sponsor the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
Attention all Medicaid beneficiaries. You can now qualify for free cell phone service with unlimited talk, text, and high-speed data. You heard that right. You can now get your cell phone service and high-speed data absolutely free from a government program called the Affordable Connectivity Program. Just call 800-211-7670 right now to see if you instantly qualify. All callers can qualify based on your income or if you receive assistance from Federal Public Housing, a Pell Grant, SSI, or even free or reduced-price school lunch programs. If you or someone in your household is enrolled in Medicaid or any other government assistance programs, you can now instantly qualify to get free cellular service and high-speed data. Plus, keep your phone number with your new free service. Even if you're paying for your plans now with another carrier, you can switch to a free talk, text, and data plan if you qualify. Just call 800-211-7670 to qualify instantly for your free talk, text, and data service. Plus, even get free high-speed internet service. This free program is open and available, so call now. Call 800-211-7670, 800-211-7670.
To the left, two receivers to the right, quarterback Crawley, a shotgun, got a quarterback in the backfield, Reynolds.
Crawley's been having a hard time today. You know, Alabama and A&M, they're giving him a hard time, but, you know, he's trying to battle through it.
Crawley calls for it, hands the ball off to his running back, and he is met by a defender, breaks the tackle, and still fighting, and was able to gain about 1 yard on the play, bringing up second and nine for the Grambling State
number
University.
Number two on the
Titans.
Carry, Chance Williams.
Yeah, Grambling's offensive line, they've been getting pushed back a little bit this whole game. I don't know if it's because of the exhaustion or what, but they got to get their heads back in it.
Crawley and shotgun calls for it, hands it out, fakes it to his running back, dump it off to his receiver. That's the
number 19 on the catch, Antonio Jones
right there for a good gain. Brings up first down, third and
number two for the
Grambling
Bulldogs,
State University.
Caleb Dawson. Third down for the Tigers.
12 minutes and 56 seconds. Crawling in shotgun. Calls for it. Crawley scans the field, looking for a receiver. Got a man right there, and it's in and out of his hands as he just took his eyes off the ball and dropped it right there. Brings up fourth down for Grambling State University. Going to be fourth and five. And Grambling, fourth and four. It's like Grambling's going to bring out their special teams to punt the ball back to this Alabama A&M team.
Just in and out of the hands of JVR Robinson. We've just seen a lot of unfamiliar things in this game. I think we need to get rid of the taunting. I think ever since we've seen that, it hasn't gone too well. Overall, this one is just, I feel like if it's not poor execution, they just haven't been able to execute on the other end. And it's been just a long day for Grambling State University football, especially in the second half. I mean, goodness.
And Grambling had to call a couple of timeouts like that. They didn't have enough men on the field, so Grambling had to use one of those timeouts right there and call. We have been seeing a lot of play calling go wrong for Grambling State University here in today's ball game.
It's a good old saying that if it's not one thing, it's another. And that's
once
what it's
again,
been for Grambling State University. I mean,
Robin
a
S.
series
Tanner,
of bad
pockets.
Events, a terms of bad events.
Ebony,
and for Grambling State University, they just have not been able to
Regina
get back.
Regina Howard, please check your pockets.
We said that they're not,
you're
they're
missing
not a first
something.
Half team.
And the today press box have has it.
Today they were a first half team. That's true. They gave it all in their first half. Because in their second half, they kind of seemed like they came out very dry. It's homecoming. And you would think that it would be different. But they came out very dry. They came out uncomfortable. They came out trying to do things that they don't usually do, trying to go big on big plays to start it off with. I mean, we're starting to see – we started to really see them fall off as far as their comfortability once we start going into the half. And then they never came back any more comfortable than it was.
And the kick is up. And as Grabner punts the ball to Alabama A&M, Alabama A&M feels it, falls to the ground, and Grambling State University player just falls right on him. So there's the penalty on the play. And that's probably going to be unnecessary roughness against Grambling State University.
Man, this is enough stress to make you go bald today.
Today.
This has been a long tough game. And this is the worst place and the worst time for to have that. I mean,
first down.
In all seriousness, Grambling State University, they just have to. I mean, there's not much you can do. There's 12 minutes and 36 seconds left, but we've been really a dormant offense so far. We haven't been able to get anything moving. We haven't looked well in the second half. We haven't looked in shape. Our defense haven't looked well. We haven't looked in shape. And that is, we have been having a hard time stopping it defensively. And I think us having a hard time stopping it defensively is because our offense is not on the field for long. Our offense have been able to just get short plays and things going and stuff for a little bit, and then our defense is right back out there. And as far as Alabama A&M, their offense has been able to stay out there, and their defense has been able to stay out there a little bit too. So everybody has somewhat more fresh legs than Grambling does.
First and 10 for Alabama A&M. Do we got another timeout on the field? Oh, wow.
They're gonna now take it to review for targeting.
Yeah.
And that's never a good telltale sign, because that in that case could be.
All right, so as they review the play, 12 minutes and 36 seconds left to go here in the fourth quarter. You score Alabama A&M 38, Grambling State University 24. We'll be back right after this on the Grambling Sports Radio Network. I used to have nothing, but now I got a whole lot of everything, and I come to study. Hey, run a two-minute break.
Building hot. They said the alumni was in the building hot. Grand fam, let's do it.
Unusual play right there, unusual tackle. So they're looking at it as to see if there was a target on the play. Oh, so that was Waters?
Yeah, I suppose so, but that's just something you just can't do, especially in a game like this. We need everything we can get. So you making that mistake just can't happen again.
Yeah, so I think so let me correct myself. I don't think that was the defensive back that did. I think that was J.R. Waters, the receiver, the 6'3 receiver that they're looking at for targeting. So we're waiting to see to get the call back from referees. And we're still at a standstill here with 12 minutes and 36 seconds to go here in the fourth quarter. And your score, Alabama A&M 38, Grambling State University 24. So, man, like I said, it was a crazy hit. Like, I thought I was watching a WWE match.
Yeah. I mean, Grambling just continues to shoot themselves in the foot. And
all right, now, in the first half so far, in the stats, we're going to take a look at them. Alabama A&M has been top of us on a couple of stats. Now, the first down, they're 20 to our 19. The rushing attempts, they have 32. And we're 32 even right now. Rushing yards is 272 for Alabama State, Alabama A&M. That is over that average, 212 is how much we give up a game. And the rest of the stats we'll get into later.
And that was target, so J.R. Waters will be kicked out of the game here as the quarterback hands it off to England, and he's up the middle for a good gain on the play. Going to make it second down, I believe.
Alabama A&M's running game has been working very well for him so far. I mean, like I said earlier, Alabama A&M's been killing Grambling with the read options and, you know, just toss plays.
Right, so, question. That means Waters' next game, Waters won't even be able to play until – will he even be able to play? Fourth quarter, until the fourth quarter. So, you know, and Waters is a big, big target for Crawley. Quarterback in shotgun, pitch it to his running back, England. England finds some room, and he is hit, but not before he gained a first down for Alabama A&M.
And that's exactly what I mean. Just run and then pitch it out. It's just working for him every time.
Makes it first and 10. First and 10 for Alabama A&M Bulldogs. Ball is now in on the Grambling's 43-yard line. So it'll be first and 10 from the Grambling's 43-yard line as Lanford is in shotgun. England is still the running back in the backfield with him. Two receivers to the left, one receiver to the right. Well, two receivers to the right, two receivers to the left, quarterback and shotgun. England in the backfield with him. Quarterback calls for it, hands it off to England, and he is hit right out the gate. And maybe 1 or 2 yards on the play. Bring up second down for the Alabama A&M.
So we're seeing the personnel kind of change up, especially in their shotgun formations, as far as what they want to do. You could kind of tell that they're on the ideal of running. They have tight end number 84 in. And when they have them in, they've been running the ball more often than not. But this is not a good thing that they are currently on track to be 300 yards rushing in this game. And this is going to be right over the average of 212 of what Grambling State University rushing yards they allow per game, and that is no bueno.
Quarterback is shotgun. Lanford and shotgun sends a man in motion. Carlton hands it off to the running back up the middle, and it's met right there, brought down maybe for no gain on the play. Bring up third and 9 to go for the Alabama A&M with 10 minutes and 2 seconds left to go here in the fourth quarter. Clock steady running, and Grambling is behind by 2 scores, and they got to find a way to get this offense off the field quickly and get the ball back and score real quick.
Oh, yeah, real quick. I mean, they're going to have to do something quickly. You got 9 minutes and 40 seconds left. That's possible to score 2 touchdowns, but you got to work with urgency. You have to make everything fast. This right now, you have to make – you got to get them off the field fast. You got to make sure this is a 3-and-out. When you get the ball, you have to score. Score and score quickly. Get out of bounds. Use as much – use as least amount of time as you can.
Langford and shotgun. Single back in the backfield with him. Sends a man in motion to – the left side of the field, but referee blows the whistle like it could be false start against Alabama A&M.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, like look like Alabama A&M called a timeout real quick. Nine minutes, 17 seconds to go here in the fourth quarter. Grambling is down by two scores. Grambling down by two scores here in the fourth quarter. And Grambling got to find a way to get this team, this offense off the field. Quick, fast, in a hurry. As you see here, Barrow's stats that just went across the board right there. And he's been one of the leading and feature backs here in the second half.
Yeah, and if you want to talk about backs, I mean, he's a quarter, but he's a back for sure. As we have number 16, their quarterback, Xavier Langford, has been putting in the same amount of work as a running back. And, I mean, as far as
he's been a running back.
I mean, he's been able to carry a lot of the yards, and I'm pretty sure we don't have the stats here. We don't have the stats here, but 272, I'm pretty sure he has a good 100 of that.
Langford and shotgun sends the man in motion. Pitches it to his running back. That's Merrill up the field. Enough for a first down and more as he has ran out of bounds around the 27-yard line. Be a first down for the Alabama A&M Bulldogs.
That's a Bulldog first
and
down.
That is no good news again as the rushing lanes hasn't been something that they could really stop. The rushing defense for Grambling has not been something to really talk about so much this season. But right now, they have to kind of step it up. These outside zones is where they're really getting beat. Everybody is being drawn inside and leaving the outside wide open. And there's not going to be any success there if you have everybody that's supposed to make a tackle, not where they're at. So I think with their running defense, they're never in the spots where they need to be, and they have to be better as positioning.
Langford, shotgun, hands it off to its running back. Number 26, so that's Murrow in the backfield, and he is hit. Maybe got back down to the line of scrimmage. Brings up second and 10 to go for Alabama A&M.
That was Kevin Thomas that came up with the nice hit, the DB. And that's what I'm talking about right there, being in the right spots. I mean, our defensive end, our linebackers got caught up inside the blocks, and our DBs was the last one to be out there. But it put a man in position. We have to be like that. We have to make sure that there's at least a man out there, somebody that can make the tackle or at least slow the player down for your team to come in. Our rush defense has not been able to do that much. It's been a lot of one-on-one tackling, and you don't like to see that when there's only one man carrying the ball.
Langford, shotgun. Merrill in the backfield with him. Sends a man in motion. Calls for it. Hands it off to Merrill up the gut, and he keeps his legs moving and still up. And finally, the whistle blown dead after gaining 5 yards on the play. Bring up third down. It'd be third and four to go for the Alabama A&M with the ball at the 25-yard line of Grambling State University.
And what's also a little familiar background to know about this, this Alabama A&M seems very aware of what's going on at Grambling, and it is very suspected because we saw our good man Brian Howard, their new SID for Alabama A&M, who was our SID here for a couple years. So you could see why Alabama A&M is quite familiar with Grambling's kind of scheme and how they're running things.
Langford with 12 carries on the night with 185 yards. As Langford fakes it to the running back, rolls to the right side of the field, finds his tight end, and he is hit and right out the game in a first down on the play.
185 yards. One touchdown, averaging 15.4 yards per carry for Xavier Langford. And that is, I mean, outstanding. 185 yards rushing for a quarterback is absurd.
And that's crazy. And not only that, but England had 16 carries for 79 yards, and Merrill 9 carries for 37 yards. So they're well over 300 yards
rushing for today, and that's just going to bring that average right on up. And for Xavier Langford, he's already combined for about 300 yards as it is right now. So a lot of that is a lot of offense that's been created for Alabama and A&M, and they're definitely staying in that number one spot.
Xavier Langford in quarterback, hands it out to Merrill up the middle for about 5 yards on the play, brings up second and 5 to go for Alabama A&M as the ball is now on the Grambling State University's 12-yard line.
Yeah, this is
on offensively wise, this is our team is really the rushing team, and overall we are struggling to even put up 100 yards total as far as rushing. But defensively, we've been able to put up a few tackles. I mean, Tally has been really doing his thing, but Alabama A&M is calling our number at every statistic, everything that we could possibly think of. There they have us.
Quarterback and shotgun rolls out to the left side of the field, keeps it himself. He's at the five, and he is finally taken down around the five-yard line, and that's going to be enough for Alabama A&M first down.
As they're slowly but surely moving that ball, I mean, they've been able to move the ball at great pace, and what they're utilizing is everything. They're not just picking and choosing players to really shine a light. I know they have Xavier Langford, and they've been able to use him a lot. But we've seen a lot of guys being able to carry the ball and also do something with it. It's all mostly – and a lot of things that we don't talk about, too, and give credit to is that offensive line for Alabama A&M has held up and held up very well against a very good defensive line of Grambling State University. So you have to be proud of every aspect for Alabama A&M if you're an Alabama A&M fan. But
Langford at shotgun keeps it itself. Fakes the pitch, keeps it himself, and he's up the middle for another touchdown for Alabama A&M.
Man, that's two touchdowns, 190 yards for him as a quarterback. I mean he's been almost unstoppable. He's been really, he fights for yards. He keeps the wheels turning. I mean, Xavier Langford is the craziest thing. I don't know if we mentioned this too much. He is a backup quarterback. The starting quarterback is not here and not playing. Quentin Casey is not playing. He's more of a passer, but, yeah, he's been able to run this game away, and now they're running away from Grambling.
Waiting on an extra point here with 4 minutes and 26 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. The kick is up, and the kick is good. With your score here now, Grambling 24, Alabama A&M 45, 4 minutes and 26 seconds to go here in the fourth quarter. We'll be back with more right after this on the Grambling Sports Radio Network. Hey, radio, if you hear me on the radio side, they're doing a two-minute break, so run a two-minute break. Two-minute break, please. 2 minutes.
Alabama A&M has 24 first downs, so our 19 first downs. Rushing attempts, Alabama A&M has 42, and we have 32. Rushing yards, they have 319 in total, and most of that is just the quarterback alone. And our rushing yards is 115. They're averaging 7.6 yards per carry. We're averaging 3.6 yards per carry, and 9 receptions they have to our 7. And overall, we're just not matching up at all points. I mean, the rushing numbers is really what's disturbing. I mean, they're putting up passing yards numbers at the running game, and that's disturbing to say the least. That's something to definitely talk about after this.
And the kick is up. Fill it. Guy
keeps it, and he is trying to find some room up the field, but he finally hit around the 42-yard line. So it'd be first and 10, Grambling to take over at their own 42-yard line here in the fourth quarter with 4 minutes and 19 seconds to go, as that last touchdown has really taken the air out of the fans here at Grambling State University.
Yeah, it's kind of taking the air out of them like a balloon. There, you know how a balloon is fully, but then you let that untwist the bottom, it just goes away. Yeah, that's the fans right now. The air has been going out, and they're making their exit as well. This has been a blunder. This has been a tough one. This is going to be one that is hard to talk about after.
Crawley shotgun, calls for it, drops back, rolls out to the left side of the field, got a man, finds a completed pass, and he is hit and taken out of bounds, close to a first down, but a little bit short, making second and maybe 2 yards to go for Grambling State University.
And they're going to let the clock roll even though he went out of bounds. Three touchdowns is the spread, and it's going to be really tough to even catch back up to be in the same facility of that three touchdowns. Alabama A&M, credit to them. They've been really able to pull away.
Crawley shotgun hands it off to Chance Williams up the gut of the field. Finds some room, and he is up the field for about a 20-plus yard gain right there. That's another Grambling State University first down.
Now, this is what I mean by them being in their identity. Now they're starting to look like they're kind of getting into it. We ran the ball. We passed the ball. And that's how we got to the 24 points. What have you seen? What are we looking back at the scoreboard? Nothing has been scored this whole half. Not a single point. And that's because of the adjustments that we made. We got uncomfortable. We started to try to do things that we don't do. We started to do things we didn't run the ball. We didn't show balance. We had plays that we had in our play sheet, but we were doing passes most of the time. We weren't really trying to open the field up and utilize everything that we have.
3 minutes and 29 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Your scorer, Alabama A&M 14-45, Grambling State University 24. Back with more right to this on the Grambling Sports Radio Network.
We are exactly what you think. We are not at all what you think. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. General Motors, honored to sponsor the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
Coach here always orders his usual, but he just met Whataburger's Southern Bacon Double with crispy bacon, crunchy slaw, and a tangy sauce. Good call, Coach. The limited time Southern Bacon Double from Whataburger. Just like you like it.
Doritos created Solid Black in 2021 to help fuel the initiatives of Black leaders seeking to drive real change. Like Alvin Irby, and his vision to spread literacy, literally. Or Marvin Pierre, who's empowering our youth with skills that bridge the opportunity gap. Or Jessica Johnson, whose dedication to dreams helps make college a reality. And many more. Check out their stories and help shape change. We are Solid Black. Join us and try another angle.
Huge play coming up.
Talking about dropping the ball.
I got the score.
Tostitos Hardy Dippers.
I believe that's number 11, Dickerson. That's a Grambling Tiger first down.
Oh,
ends the field, got a man on the corner of the end zone, and great, great coverage right there by Alabama A&M, was able to bat that down on the play.
Yes, great job to reach the top of the pinnacle and really get that ball at the top of his contact, and that was a great defense by Alabama A&M, and quite frankly, great defense all the way, all that was the second half for Alabama A&M, been able to execute so.
2 minutes, 53 seconds left to go here in the fourth quarter. Crawling and shotgun. Collinsport hands it off to the running back, and he is met in the backfield and taken down. Great, just great defense right there. And the first person in on that was Hayes, the defensive end for Alabama A&M, was able to bring him down for a loss of yards on the play.
And that one is it's tough again as they continue to go backwards.
Gonna bring up third and long for Grambling State University. Third and about 15 yards to go. Crawley in shotgun, single back in the backfield. Whittle calls for it, drops back, scans the field, looks for a man across the middle of the field. Got him in the end zone. Did he bring it in? It is incomplete. Gonna bring up fourth down for Grambling State University.
That one was closer than it could have been. The catch was almost there, almost reeled in, but just couldn't get it in. And now that's just been the game so far. That's what we've been seeing. Grambling State University, of course, is going to go for a touchdown here. I mean, you know, you might as well.
What else you got to lose here?
Might as well throw rocks in the well.
2 minutes, 15 seconds to go here in the fourth quarter. Crawley is still on the field. Offense stay on the field for this fourth down play. Crawley is shotgun. Looks for a man, got a man across the middle of the field, well, on the outside, and that's number eight. That's number 19, Antonio Jones for Grambling on the completion there, and it's short of the first down. That's short of the first down, so that's going to be a turnover on down for Grambling State University.
That's the kicker, man. That is the kicker. There's a lot to get into as far as this game, but, you know, we don't want to sound like we're beating dead horses here. It's just that overall, the same problems that we've been kind of seeing in this game is what we've been seeing all season. The rushing defense has just been something that really needs work on. I think that needs to maybe another defensive formation or just work in general. But our rushing defense has not really been all the way there. And today is really shown as far as the rushing yards that's been put up, 300-plus rushing yards, and that just added to the total.
As Alabama A&M comes back out, quarterback hands it out to the running back, England, straight up to Miller of the field, and he just runs over a Grambling State University player, keeps his leg moving the game, about 20 yards on the play, the first and 10 to go for Alabama A&M, and Alabama A&M now has the ball on their own 32-yard line.
You cannot convince me that man is 5'11", 226. There's no way.
No way.
He has to be the minimum 6'2", 235. But he's been able to run the ball quite well. And now we're going to see Alabama A&M drain this clock down and get in victory formation.
1 minute, 19 seconds to go, left to go in this ball game here as the quarterback for Alabama A&M just got under the field and went straight to and kneeled the ball right there on the play. As OJ just showed me something they put on camera. OJ, don't do that no more, man.
I don't know what you're talking about. I didn't do anything.
The camera crew, don't do that no more.
Don't do that. That's them. That was them.
40 seconds left to go here in this ball game. As they just letting the clock run down here. 35 seconds. And there goes another knee for Alabama A&M quarterback. So that's going to be the end of the ball game here. With your score, Alabama A&M 45, Grambling State University 24 here at homecoming for Grambling State University.
This is a good win for Alabama A&M. Tough loss for Grambling. I mean, now you're 2-2 in the SWAC. I mean, now no longer in that number one spot as far as the SWAC West Southern most likely have. We'll have to see how their games turn out. But this one was a kind of a must-win for Grambling. This is one of the toughest games that we had on our schedule until we go see Southern. And in that meantime, this is a homecoming game. This is a very important event. So you want to win a very important big event when it comes like that and be prepared for the next big event. So this is a tough loss. You have to always look forward to next week. This one is going to ponder a little bit, maybe be a little bit forgetful for players and people today because it's homecoming. But this will last on the record. So we'll see how everything pans and turn out to be.
All right, so, man, you like it once again, your score here, Grant.